This one's for all my baby girls. I see your comments, ladies, and they make me smile. I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it. But lately, I've just been taking care of my business and getting my grind on. But I promise you, I'll be back to play and get my flirt on. This one's for all my baby girls. I see your comments, ladies, and they make me smile. I'm lurking and I'm stalking. I'm lurking. I'm lurking. I'm lurking.
Another one. Another one. Another one.
DJ Khaled. Yo.
Plain protect.
Plain Jane.
Fill it with ice.
Ice.
Yo. Save your check.
Woo.
You don't know the price.
No.
Yeah. Pull up McLaren the wings. Pull
I'm
up
lurking.
My wings.
I'm
I came from dumping my jeans. I came from dumping my jeans.
Bag.
Alert. Major bag.
I'm lurking.
Alert, major bag alert.
Major
bag alert. Major bag alert.
Major
bag alert.
You're still
major
on mission
bag,
one.
Alert.
Bag
alert. Major bag
some
alert.
Some weirdo.
I'm born a 50 before I begin. Petty for leap with the snow in the wind. She disrespectful, so I nut on the chin. Then I draw down, so I'm gangsta again. Bag alert, bag alert, bag alert, bag alert. Nigga be copping the swaggler. Add it up, stack it up, add it up, stack it up.
Your life.
They cut off
not
the straggler, cut them off. It's in the back of the truck, it's up, push it the banner, then hit the horn, bumper bumper. All of my pockets got lumps on lumps. Pull out this stick, nigga, bumper bumper. She don't want me, but I know it's
gonna
cat.
Stay on my dick.
Hold up my bus, and I'm proving the point. Just slap on my fuck about hit like a
get
you had a big bad, but somehow
I'm lurking.
When your life and the hype and the pockets go down. When you take up the blood and the press,
I'm lurking.
Dodge a few obstacles, dodge a few rounds. When you having that shit, you can buy you
I'm lurking.
Buy you a mountain. Got the Bentley, the Rave, and the Lambo, no mileage. Bentley, the Rave, and the Lamb. Now go get the Blue G's, the Rackets, whatever you call them.
Playing for tech,
playing Jane.
Fill it with ice,
ice.
Yeah. Save your check.
Woo.
You don't know the price.
No.
Yeah. Pull up my clean the wings. Pull up and spread my wings.
Me.
Yeah. I came from dumping my jeans. I came from dumping my jeans.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Welcome. Major bag alert.
Major. Major bag alert. Major bag alert.
First,
did it.
Pass the work,
pay.
Then ask the perk,
cookie.
Got ass to convert.
She
flirt, then slurp.
Slurp.
Say you won't talk major bag alert. Say he got the air, but that's capillary.
Yeah.
But nigga, that pop off his smack alert.
God damn it, this song is so loud and so long. Hello, everybody. Welcome, chat. Massive shout out to Tyler Grimmie for becoming a member and for the massive $50 super chat. Big ups, Tyler. Thank you very much. We hadn't even started yet, dude. He's setting the bar very high. Who's gonna get to name the Pokemon? Come on, guys. You need to engage. Please.
You don't know the price. I know. Pull up McLaren the wings. Pull up and spread my wings.
Like the stream. We're going for 5,000 likes on this stream. Hopefully. If we reach that goal, there's a tier 2 goal of 10,000 likes. This song is so long. Let's get a little bit more sensual, more emotional, get in the vibe of what we're gonna watch today. You know what I mean? We're gonna watch DSP guilt trip his fans. Obviously. He's gonna dunk on the trolls. Like he's Michael Jordan, he's Zion Williamson. He's dunking on these trolls every day. We got owned. Meanwhile, he's using troll intros and outros every day.
I'm trying to give them to you.
You're gonna stay on my dick.
I'm trying to bust out loyal.
You're gonna stay on my dick.
That's a long hoe. I love the way you walk. Love the way you talk. Let a young nigga come play your throat. Deep stroke your throat.
I'm lurking. I'm lurking. I'm lurking. I'm lurking and I'm stalking.
I'm trying to bust out loyal. Got a little honor. That's if you want it.
Yeah, Sifu is gonna beat his ass. And I got beans you bite down. Gonna destroy his ass. Probably. Or he already watched all the guides. That's also possible. It's entirely possible.
You're gonna stay on my dick until you die.
I need to put this trusting food in the mouths of my family members.
Damn, babe got me tripping. BOA head made me con instant. She ain't even gotta ask for attention. Cause I'ma give it to her. Money I give it to her. Cock on rocks I give it to her. Sexy little bitch, sexy little hoe. I love the way you walk, love the way you talk. Let a young nigga come play in your throat. Deep stroke your throat till I make you choke. Throw baby.
I'm lurking.
I'm trying to give him.
I'm lurking.
Throw baby.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect.
Sexy little bitch, sexy little hoe. I love the way you walk, love the way you talk.
You're
let a young nigga come play in your throat. Deep stroke your throat till I make you choke. Throw baby.
That's retarded.
I'm trying to give him tail. Throw baby.
Some weird like
I'm
porno.
To bust all on you. Cecilia red bone.
I love
gotta
my
get
life.
Head on her. Cecilia red bone.
Hello everybody. First I think I'm gonna watch like 10 episodes of Snort Brunel. That's gonna be exciting. Oh wait, I gotta plug Discord first. Alright, well while this is playing, well we're getting emotional. You can go to the link in chat to access the Mega Chill Discord, where everything is happening except gay ops and dumb retarded shit. Hopefully, it's very chill. We have rooms for everybody. You can post your pets. You can request stream ideas and shit. We got bots to repost DSP. As you can see, he says it's Sifu Day, and then you can write DSP. That's retarded. And yeah, you can act like you talk to DSP. It's super chill. So yeah, you can go there. And we have custom emotes and stickers, custom style, like all of this amazing shit. All of these. Now we have the Kool-Aid DSP. We have the Cult DSP. I love the Cult DSP. It's very fun, with the nice cult hat. Anyways, let's get into the Snort Brunel. There's so much Snort Brunel to watch, it's impossible. Alright, let's go back to the page that was. Hello everybody, welcome to the stream. As always, we're gonna be chilling with Phil. It's like the best thing you could do. Snort Brunel, let's find the guy. And let's start the chill. I have a lot to catch up. I haven't been alive in like 6 days, I think. Maybe it's a week. So let's see what I missed. Okay, let's start from here. Slow night and complaining about it. And then we're gonna build up the whole arc of how he wasn't actually complaining about it.
Motherfucking piece of shit.
Hey, big ups for the chill.
I'm coming for you. I'm gonna find out who the fuck you are. You
I'm lurking. I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
Live on the internet. You are done.
Wow, this one is so loud. So long. Big ups 51915 for the $10 tip. Thank you for the chill just before we started, and now we can get started with it. Okay, let's go. Let's get super toxified. I'm gonna get so mad because he owned me, man. He owned me. I was like, oh my god, Phil didn't make any money, man. And then the pay pigs came and gave him a lot of money. I felt so owned. I couldn't sleep all night. So yeah, it was beyond ownage. It was like real estate. Like he just purchased the entire real estate of my life. That's how angry I was. That some random bum on the internet got money. oh yeah, I'm gonna condition you all to like this stream. I will play you subconscious stuff like signs. Okay.
Turn on the ovens.
Okay, when I play this one, you're gonna like the stream, okay?
Turn on the oven. Turn on the oven. Turn on the oven.
You liked it five times, huh? Alright, let's get started. Let's stop fucking around.
Holy shit! That is an epic fucking intro, dude.
And I have to warn everyone. Warning. What you may see right now is going to be absolutely disgusting.
Sound good?
Alright.
Sound good?
Sounds good to me.
Tonight, hello, everybody in chat that is just joining.
Really appreciate it. All right. If
now the plan for today is I go through as many Snort Brunel as possible to cover as much ground, and then I might watch some of the bigger highlights of the Dying Light complaining and the other complaining.
Tipper.
There was so much complaining, man. I don't know what's wrong with him.
By the end of tonight's stream,
outside of everything,
we'll get to name a Pokemon in the game. You may notice. Right.
Yeah, he's selling Pokemon again.
Right,
what
here,
the fuck?
My main starter Pokemon named by Jade last time around. He was the top tipper, and he got to name him Raz, which is really cool. And everyone else will be able to do that as well. Whoever the top tipper is by the end of the stream, and I wonder who it will be and what Pokemon they will choose to name.
Wow. Kevin Bernstein did super chat asking, "What are my favorite balls? Beach ball."
Oh, the troll outro. I forgot. Like I always forget. I always forget stuff on these streams. It's like a troll meme. The troll outro, DSP Gaming outro. It's fantastic. He intentionally, I mean accidentally, cut out the footage from the on-demand videos. So yeah, let's see what it is.
Sound good?
Look, now it's gonna be, oh, accidentally.
Good to you, because it sounds good to me. Let's do it. All right. Until next time, my friends.
Now he's gonna stop recording in case it's a troll. Oh, that's something else. That was the old one. Yeah, that was the old one. But Anne has all of them. And let's see this one here. The new podcast outro. The guy has a massive production crew working on this show. Every day he has new assets. Phenomenal. This is the best podcaster in life. Okay.
I accidentally stopped recording.
Bill?
I didn't mean to do that.
I accidentally, of course.
Shit. I have a new outro to show you guys, and I clicked on stop recording instead of mute the mic like a fucking idiot. So now the people on YouTube won't see the new outro. Shit.
How unfortunate.
Well, you guys get to see it. Ready?
All right. Anytime now, Dave. Okay, let's take a look. Thanks for tuning in. Smash that like button. That was, by the way, Life at the Outpost. You guys already know this is this old news at this point. Life at the Outpost, very positive song. Now he got the Street Fighter from that old movie. Subscribe to my channel, very nice. And now it's my day off. Very fucking positive, super chill. I spend money on pulls and dumb shit, of course. And then we're back to gacha machines. This guy is so oblivious. How? DSP, you're not owning us like this. I don't feel owned right now. I just feel like laughing a little bit at how oblivious this guy is. Oh my god. He takes all the bait. He takes even more bait than I do. It's crazy. Okay, and we're back.
Hey, did you guys like this? There you go. I think it needs some more work.
Very fucking nice. And he had a new frame as well, as you can see here, because his camera and the frame, they're not aligned and they're not grouped within OBS. So it's two separate objects, which makes it much easier to do everything. You know what I mean? Big ups Klaus Mystery for a super chat. DSP doesn't know pachinko is gacha. Well, it is. It's exactly like the same idea. The gacha gamer, man. But he doesn't know, as long as there's no WWE champions playing Candy Crush on it, it's not gacha. Let's go back to the Pokemon thing.
Oh, let's see.
But big ups for that outro, it was great.
Balzac. Who remembers the game Balzac from the 1990s? Go look that up.
So now we're up to $18 in tips, guys.
I know he thinks he's professional with the intro and the outro. But it actually make his stream look more chaotic because they're also random.
Because if you want to be professional, it all kind of needs to be working together, as in all your color schemes and all your designs and all your assets that you use, they need to work together well. While all his shit is just chaotic, random shit. So it doesn't make him look professional, it makes him look like a bum. Which is, coincidentally, exactly what he is.
Excellent, we're on our way to hitting the tier 1 goal, which will be Gunner Glasses. Remember, tonight when we hit the different tiers, you get different rewards. At 100, it's a hat, and we have different hats in the rotation. Yes, the Pikachu hat is still in rotation, but now we have a Skyrim hat that's also in the rotation that I could wear tonight. Or we could do, like, the pilot or the cowboy hat, too.
Oh my god, he's drinking gin. Gin is great.
By the way, guys, we're about a half an hour into tonight's stream. If you're having a good time on the stream tonight, please consider giving the stream a like here on YouTube.
Giving a like. At this point, what is kind of funny for me with DSP is when he stops at the middle of the stream or like 40 minutes into the stream to beg, I'm not sure what he's going to beg about. Because, you know, a couple of weeks ago, I knew he was going to beg for tips. Because now he can beg for members, or he can beg for likes, or he can beg the on-demand people to comment stuff on his videos. As we're gonna learn later on, there was one great segment when he was asking people to basically give him fake engagement, as in writing a completely unrelated comment to his content. It was very good. Very good.
I believe we're around 60, so we're doing good. It would be great if we could be
around 60. Come on, you gotta hit the target. Why did you even clock in today if you're not gonna hit the target?
On YouTube,
come on, video. I'm busting your ass. You need to bust your ass too. We're not here to have fun.
Please consider giving it a like if you're having a good time. And also consider leaving a comment, whether you have to talk about something going on in the game or just want to say what you think about the video. I would
appreciate. Oh yeah, what about something else? What if I want to say something about Kanye West or Obama?
Wait a minute.
Oh, it's DSP.
Hold on a
second. Yeah. Balloon Race. Like, oh no, that's not his name. Thought his name
he
is Balloon Race.
Look at this guy's face. Kind of looks like someone.
Yeah, you from like 10 years ago. Now you look like a ghost. Now you look like the ghost of the guy from 10 years ago.
Wow. They actually put me in the game. Does he have the same bald spot as me too? No.
The bald spot. I thought the bald spot didn't exist.
I'm seriously in it.
The trolls were making up the bald spot, and now the bald spot is just a self-deprecating joke. Ah, holy shit, I opened my own stream by accident.
Holy shit!
Wanted to play some fucking music, man.
Too. I'm very upset. But anyway...
Bozo the Clown.
Bozo the Clown.
So, ladies and gentlemen, PewDiePie gets himself into YouTuber's life too. Well, guess what, motherfucker? Guess what?
False.
Pokemon, bitch. I don't know. You guys don't understand. I literally live in a bubble.
So shout out to Kevin who did a super chat. He says, I want him to name Meowth Jasper. That would be cool. I mean, yeah, that would be cool if we had a Meowth named Jasper. But number one, I haven't caught a Meowth yet. And number two, you're not the top tipper, so you can't ask for anything.
Oh my god, he's drinking gin.
It sure would be great if we could have some tips. We have not hit any of the tips.
The show tonight would be great.
Please, if you're enjoying yourself, please support the stream if you can.
Really?
Absolute last chance. If you're looking to contribute.
Absolute last chance.
The top CM Fools tip of
$11. So cool.
Stream. Okay, you have to be the top.
Last chance. The plane is taking off. Have you bought a ticket yet? Come on, we're going to heaven. Just drink the Kool-Aid now. Put on the Nike shoes. Okay. What are you doing? Get back here.
It's a little unfortunate. It would have been great if we could have had some more contributions tonight.
Come on, we're going to heaven. The spaceship is going to pick us up. Come on. Just drink the Kool-Aid. Don't think about it.
I don't know if it's the contributions today has slowed down as a result of it being a night stream or a result of it just being Pokemon. I don't know, because the two times I played it before, it actually went quite well. But also, it was really stinks about this is, if we get people who contribute last minute right now to try to name a Pokemon... Again, there's no time for a hat. There's no time for any reward.
There's no time.
I'm trying to tell you guys, if we're going to contribute, please do it earlier so we have time for things like a poll for a hat or something, you know.
But contribute earlier.
In reality, it's looking like no one's going to top CM Fool.
This fucking guy fascinates me every day that I live. Every day that I tune into him, he fascinates me. Not only is he begging for money, he's begging for the money at specific points of the night where it makes sense to him, to his business, to get the money. It's a very nice incentive, so you get the reward for longer, and he gets to have security and to stop giving a fuck about the stream and just wait for the time to clock out. Exactly. He's fantastic. I fucking love this.
So I guess it is what it is.
Oh, what a fucking reality show. But we're gonna get to that
Oh, everyone, please contribute so we can...
That's a part of the I own the trolls rant.
Really stick it to those trolls tonight and make them...
Yeah, let's stick it to the trolls.
I hope you guys had a good time. I personally had a good time. Now, want to be honest? Yeah.
Let's make people on the internet angry that don't have any stakes in my life or care at all outside of making fun of me. Let's make them angry.
I'm a little disappointed that the two times I played Pokemon as a main gameplay stream, we had tons of support, like overwhelming support. And some people are saying, oh, it's because there's that one guy who every day, named One Minute Man, who tips a big...
Yeah. It's literally a habit at this point.
If he had been here tonight and tipped, we still wouldn't have even hit the tier 2 tips goal. You see?
The tier 2 goal.
What that tells me is that maybe there was a different audience for the game during the day who liked it, and now they can't attend the night streams or something? Because how is it that I did this twice?
You know how we're going to own the PayPigs. Everybody like this video right now. This is how we own the PayPigs. DSP, he's going to see this stream, and he's going to click on it and open it. And see that I'm making fun of him, and it's gonna have like 10 million likes, and he's gonna feel owned.
I mean, actually,
I promise. Like, just trust me, man. And then, drink this Kool-Aid.
And all of a sudden, I play as the very first time I play as an ice stream, and it's all.
You want some ice?
Right. Well, all I can do is I can try talking about this on the pre-stream. I can try talking about this on the daily wrap. I can tweet about it. I can try to make awareness of it so that people are aware of what's going on and see if we can bring more support. Because yeah, it kind of sucks that this game is going to be very lengthy, and I'm only 8 hours in. Right. This is gonna be like.
It kind of sucks.
Every week. Now, obviously, I want people to come by and support it.
Bro, I can't believe this. Okay. I literally can't believe this. He has, like, what? Let's see. Let's say 300 people a stream or whatever. It doesn't really fucking matter, the number of people. But he expects $300 a day. Or at least $200 a day. While working as a streamer. Like, a very below average streamer. It's like, bro, come on, be realistic a little bit. What the fuck? Those people, they're not made of money or gold or platinum or diamonds. Come on, what the fuck do you expect? You're not that important. You're not saving society. He expects so much from random people on the internet that just want to chill. No, pay my taxes, pay my back taxes, pay my utilities.
Pay my taxes, pay my back taxes, pay my utilities, pay my mortgage. Pay my internet bill, pay my utilities.
I think it was a great stream. We had good conversation. You guys were helping me out and learning about Pokemon evolutions and stuff. And we had good
conversation. Yeah, he is pushing what he's got.
Everything was good except the contributions weren't.
Everything was good except the main thing.
I can really do about that.
What is this framing? Everything was good except literally my salary.
Besides, say, I wonder what happened. And maybe make people a little bit more aware.
But everything was good, though.
I'm actually very much looking forward to the next stream in a couple of days. All right, I want to say thank you. You guys were a great audience. Thanks to everyone who chilled. I mean, we had over 100 likes on the stream, which is great. Attendance was pretty decent for a late-night Pokemon stream. Everything there was good. It was just contribution, so...
Oh, fuck. I need more money. I need money. Come on. I need money.
I would like to kind of fess up with you guys a little bit and be honest and transparent with all of you. Last night, I had...
Let's see. We're going to get the honesty segment.
It was our first night.
I'll be honest. Yesterday, you didn't give me money. So I'm gonna scold you for that, and you should feel bad, and you should step up. Wait, I forgot to read a super chat. Big ups, Klaus Mystery, for the super chat. He's so delusional, he thinks Pokemon is not mainstream. Pokemon was, like, the number one sold game on the PSN for this month, I think. I saw something like that on Twitter. So it is a pretty big game. I guess just people don't give a fuck about watching him play Pokemon, because he's dumb. Big ups, potential Kool-Aid drinker. Oh, we need to convert this one. Does the Kool-Aid have Jenna natural spices? It's a deciding factor, TBH. I don't know what to answer with this. I don't know. I need to think of something more disgusting than this.
Stream of Pokemon Legends Arceus.
But big ups.
You know, late night session.
$1. Potential Kool-Aid drinker.
Viewers, which is fine. I had a good time with that.
The whole thing with Jenna and the fucking Kool-Aid, man, that shit was traumatic. Holy fuck.
But man, it just felt like very different from the first two times that I played the game. When I played it Friday and Saturday as a new release, we had more people in attendance. We had more people engaging with the content.
But drink the Kool-Aid, dude. Just believe me. If you like me as a person and as a human being, just buy in. Just drink the Kool-Aid.
It was like all of it slowed down to a crawl. And I was actually quite disappointed.
Slowed down. You should call him lazy again. That went great last time.
All of a sudden, it was like because I made it from a day to night stream.
And you should say a hateful slur.
People were complaining it was boring. And not to say it was everyone. I'd say it was about 60-70% of the people who were there were engaged and having fun, but there was a group of people sitting there saying, man, this is boring. Like, oh, wait a minute.
How do you know all these statistics? 60 to 40.
I played these two major streams previously in the week. We
all. So why are they there if they're bored?
I like the fact that this game has some action-based mechanics as opposed to just turn-based, top-down, you know, RPG-style gameplay. It's a very different kind of game, and I like that about it. It's actually refreshing, all right? So why attitudes changed just because I shifted the stream from a day stream to a night stream was a little confusing. Obviously,
bro, you should stop having this bullshit day stream, night stream nonsense. You should stream like an actual work shift. Just like 8 hours with some break and just one stream a day. What is this bullshit with two streams? You upload so many videos. It gets so annoying.
B is people are going to be at different...
But I know, he's built his shitty business in such a terrible way that you can't scale it, you can't change it up in any time without fucking yourself over. It's ridiculous.
Be attending the late stream and the night stream.
It was
right?
The gravy
and then what
train,
Big Papa Phil just said, of course,
I was
you just be careful.
Insane amounts of money. Like, dirty, rotten, this is way too much fucking money for just playing video games kind of money.
Big Ups, chill Kool-Aid drinker for the $5. Please name a Pokemon Officer Sanders. I don't play Pokemon, but I totally would. If we could have something like that, like a virtual mascot on the screen, I could probably pull off something like that. Big Ups for the tip.
Right?
I'm going to consider something like that, I guess.
Right. Either
like
right.
A Pokemon.
So here's what I want to say.
And we're going to run a poll every time how it's going to be called or something. I don't fucking know. It might have a vest. You know, different vests. We're going to get interactive.
I'm doing it again as the late stream.
Sounds good.
Tomorrow night. Please, if you missed out on the first one yesterday, please attend it. And please chill out with me. Have a good time. If you can,
please have fun with me.
I always do this.
I'm so fun. I just make everything be about my life.
Pokemon playthroughs now.
But everything else is fun.
Whoever is the top tipper by the end of that particular...
Yeah, he is. He is, in fact, as least efficient as he can be. This is the one thing that I know about DSP. He physically could not get less efficient with anything that he does.
Gets to actually name a Pokemon. In the game.
We named the Pokemon, okay.
This is cool because that Pokemon keeps that name for the whole playthrough. You know, there were Pokemon in Sword and Shield.
Wow.
That were named.
No, you lose all the rights to say excuse me.
The playthrough. We're talking 40, 50 hours of gameplay. You still see that guy.
It's not an accident.
It's kind of neat to be a part of that playthrough in that way. So, what happened? Well, we had someone named CM Fool, regular to the stream.
I think the naming a Pokemon scam is a pretty efficient one. Because it's like some shit that is kind of creative. But it wasn't even his idea.
He's a regular supporter. He did an $11 tip like
CM4, a pay pig. Pay pig confirmed.
So he just sat there as the top tipper the entire stream. There was, you know.
Does he know about Officer Sanders? At this point, I would say so. Because there were a lot of references to her and like $11.95 and stuff like that. I would say he should know. But he's also oblivious of all the memes that were in his outro and intro literally yesterday. So I don't know. Well, not literally yesterday. That was his day off.
Name a Pokemon, The Rock.
Where he put disgusting food in the mouths of his family members.
I need to put disgusting food in the mouths of my family members.
So I did. I named the fighter Pokemon Machop, The Rock. Because as he levels up, you may realize this, he turns into a pro wrestler. So I was like, oh, that makes sense. The Rock, a pro wrestler, should do that, right? But I couldn't believe it. Like, I was like, wow, this is different. Back when I was playing Pokemon games, you know, a year or two ago. People would actually be very excited and motivated to name a character, to be competing, to try to get the name of the character.
AJ Kramer, like, what's up?
Not very exciting last night. I had fun, don't get me wrong. I had a good time with my...
When am I gonna make an intro? Dude, I was the first one to make an intro. It's on my second channel. I was literally the first one to make an intro. I'm a pioneer of dumb bullshit on the internet. Just like DSP. I'm just as good as DSP, confirmed. Wait, what was this? I forgot how my channel was called. Okay, here it's on the Sock Account channel. Here it is. This is my intro. Darkside Phil is a beggar, man. He begs for everything he can. He's toxic and he looks like trash. It's the pre-stream podcast. But not really a podcast, but kind of is, but it's not. And it sucks. Yeah, and I also would never send him this because it's, I don't know. I don't even think he would see it because he's dumb. Big Ups potential Kool-Aid drinker. Can I have my Kool-Aid in a fake pink cylinder thing that shoots it in my mouth? It's okay if some of it ends up on my face. You wanted like those, what was the name of that juice? I forgot. I fucking forgot. The whole joke fell apart. Never mind, but Big Ups for a tip. You can have your Kool-Aid in whatever you want. You can literally inject it in you as long as you take it. You need to take it.
There you go.
You really need to.
It was a good chill stream.
It's good for you. You're not going to get harassed by people on the internet. Just drink it.
But it really felt like a different attitude towards Pokemon for some odd reason. I didn't understand it because previously Pokemon had done pretty well on my streams, okay? So, I would hope that maybe some people just missed it, or I don't know. Let's see how it does tomorrow night, all right? Because the thing is, this is supposed to be my lengthy ongoing chill stream for the month. Like, it was going to be Pokemon and Skyrim balanced on the late streams while I was doing all new release content on the early streams. I just hope that it works out, okay? Really, I hope that it works out. That it doesn't end up being a stream that gets less and less attendance, less and less support, and it ends up being dead. That would suck. Especially because, like I said, this is the most innovative Pokemon
game. That would suck. Hint, hint. Pay up.
I'm not sure why that would happen. You'd think more people would be engaged in it.
I don't know why, man. It's almost like it's... I don't know. It's not that complicated. It really isn't.
It's very odd.
I need a drink.
Yeah. Take a sip.
That's retarded.
That green alcohol's good.
I'm lurking.
People think for some reason that all I do is sit around drinking gin all day.
So here we go. Here come the trolls. So there's fuck them. It's gonna be
here comes the trolls.
I'm not gonna read what they say.
Not gonna read anything. But how are you gonna know what to ban? You're not gonna read it. How are you gonna know who's a troll?
Why was that deleted? Because they're assholes. That's
don't even ask. You have to explain yourself to people on the internet.
Like that. Oh, look,
well, why I deleted this message is he called me out of my bullshit.
Got deleted in chat. Why they got deleted?
Okay.
So fuck them. There you go.
I didn't read it, but I'm gonna delete it instantly.
Banned. Gone forever.
All right, so Malcolm did another $1.50. He said, "Put my headphones on now. No one but me can hear your voice." I did get a few comments from people because of your mouth. There you go.
Oh, the stroke mouth. The meme.
What did they think my mouth is?
The stroke meme.
Oh, come on. Listen, when I was young, my friends called me Phil with the oddly shaped head.
Wow, really? They did.
My head.
Bro, this needs to go on the clown board. Holy fuck.
I'm lurking.
Stay!
They saw him and they were like, "Hey, it's Phil with the oddly shaped head. Stay back."
Stay!
Incest Phil, that's how they called him.
It's very weirdly shaped.
His family tree is a circle.
Like, I believe
that's why he looks like that.
Naturally come out, so they had to rip.
And also his mom was smoking hard. She was stalking.
Was to rip me out physically. So I think what happened is they clamped my head.
It was hotboxing.
Just crushed it and deformed it. So it's weird.
Wait, what? What? Off. What?
Ashamed to admit this. My head is very weirdly shaped. It's like when I was a baby, maybe they were like, I believe when I was being born, I wouldn't naturally.
It was a time traveler. They tried to kill him. A time traveler from the future who know that in the end of the day, Phil just absorbs everything. And the world ends. So they tried to kill him when he was a baby.
Had to rip me out of my mom, like they use like
these. Wow, yeah, they had to rip him out.
Rip me out physically.
It was.
So I think what happened is they clamped my head and they crushed it and deformed it. So it's weird. My head is very.
They crushed my head and deformed it.
God, it's not a normal human.
So it's weird. You should drop the pig head emoji in the chat. The emoji, bro. What am I, fucking boomer? Oh, I agree with you, dude. The fucking hair is, not the hair, but the everything.
With the oddly shaped head. But now you're telling me people are making fun of my lips?
Yeah, stroke. Absolutely.
What's wrong with my lips? Come on.
Something else.
Absolutely disgusting. Absolutely.
Literally.
Oh. Benefactor. Oh. And, that is disgusting. Disturbing and disgusting. Oh my
God. And that was it for this episode of Stroke Burnell. This should be the new channel, Stroke Burnell. Now what do we have? Rage quitting, wage quitting, Halo, gifted memberships, and begging for credits. This stream is gonna be like 16 hours long. Holy shit.
Let's play the game.
Big ups Black Mage 666 for the super chat. This story is a lie stolen from Sylvester Stallone. Wait, the head story that they called him the guy with the weird shaped head? Why would he steal something from Sylvester Stallone? Big ups to I'm a Villain 1 for the $4.99 super chat. Linda tied downstairs confirmed. Holy shit. Yeah, his mom is she's a wonderful lady. Big ups Paul J. Brazzle for a super chat. One side of his nose is bigger than the other. I'm gonna pay attention to this. Let's see if that's true.
Oh my God!
If I see it once, I'm not gonna be able to unsee it.
Just like with his mouth.
That is an epic fucking intro, dude.
That was an epic intro. And yeah, his mom 100% smoked. She 100% did.
Sound good?
All right. Sounds good to me.
Tonight will be kind of like the last hurrah for Halo. And
the last hurrah.
Until they actually do release new content. They said there's a roadmap, and apparently later this year, there will
be a fuck roadmaps. They're always a scam. Remember when Anthem had a roadmap? Anthem. That game is beyond the grave.
I'd rather give it a rest until then.
It's in a different universe.
It's kind of the last hurrah. We're going to just play some random matches here tonight, try to have fun, try to have a good time, and give Halo a proper send-off.
The last hurrah.
Let's see how it goes.
Okay, professional. Miss, 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 miss. And died. This is my favorite gameplay.
I think it's lagging bad. It says 60
minutes. Oh, it's lagging bad. That's,
Wow, that's massive.
That's a good explanation.
Wow. What the fuck? No wonder I can't hit anything. This is ridiculous, man. Fuck this shit.
He rage quit!
And rage quit. But it's okay, because it was lagging. He had an excuse.
Are you fucking serious?
Fuck this laggy fucking bullshit. That's terrible. I can't even move. I can't even move the aim. Left and right. It's like, like underwater. Fuck that. Try it again. Hold on, you better fucking
what?
Match. What a terrible first match.
What a terrible match.
He's drinking salt.
He's drinking salt? These random edits get me all the time. There was one with, he's drinking sperm. It was just so fucking random. Alright. This was some good skill. Almost hit him. And dead. And now the complaints begin.
That's wow!
Wow!
Wow! He was dancing! Ah, that's funny. Damn!
Stabbed gout.
Instantly died to an energy sword.
Instantly died. That's how it works sometimes.
Waited for this shit. Look at the weapons they're fucking giving me.
I prefer instantly dying than dying in Battlefield 5, where you just fall on the floor and you wait until you actually die.
And then, dude, it's the same guy. Rage quit again. I made him rage quit again.
You made me wait all that time to give the opposite team every good weapon and give me 3 bad loadouts.
Yeah, this is Snort Burnell.
Piece of shit.
I'm catching up with what happened during this week. And there's a lot of just dumb DSP shit. Alright. And clapped from the back. Hit it from the back. Let's get to the complaining and begging for tips. Let's see, it should be here. Hey, you guys, it's 40 minutes into the stream. We haven't had a tip in 40 minutes.
It makes no fucking sense that just happened.
What?
Such a goddamn scrub. I suck. I'm a scrub.
All right, guys, absolute last chance. If you'd like to give a look.
Yeah, scrub is a guy who thinks he's fly, also known as a busta.
Particular tips would help the most if you would like to. Thank you in advance.
Tips help the most.
DSP signing off for Halo Infinite, and I'll be back when the game updates.
Hey, what's up, Flip?
Thank you so much, and I will see you then. All right. I'm just not making any money tonight. Oh, everyone, please contribute so we can really stick it to those trolls tonight and make them.
Ladies and gentlemen, YouTube has entered the alpha phase of
Yay! Congratulations. This filter is terrifying, by the way.
Memberships.
Absolutely terrifying.
In Japan only.
So yeah, why not?
Why are they testing this in Japan?
Might be because it's a smaller country-ish, I guess, a smaller market, and also the technology is good. I don't fucking know. Well, I legit don't.
Matter-of-factly, in business...
Oh, let's see. DSP is going to tell us, though.
It makes sense. Here's why.
Okay.
You have a smaller group of people.
Yeah, that's what I
that
said.
That could be your test.
Stole my opinion.
See what I'm saying? If they all of a sudden made it entirely all over the world, boom, worldwide gifted memberships. What if they don't...
Yeah, that's not how it...
Break?
Yeah, literally. But you were bitching about them not implementing it literally last year, and that they had to stop doing everything. He said, Susan, put down the sandwich and go make the gifted memberships. That's what he said. And now it's the opposite side. Oh, why would you release it to everybody worldwide? What if it doesn't work? Yeah, he said, drop the ham sandwich. This fucking asshole. And now it's the completely opposite. Yeah, they need to make sure it's working. And when he said the bullshit with the sandwich, I told him, dude, they need to make sure it was working. And he called me mentally ill shithead and
a human piece of shit or something. I don't know. Entire never called me anything.
Site and all the business, right?
I'm just lying. I'm just putting words in his mouth. If I'm going to slander him, I'm going to go all the way. I literally make up scenarios about me and him. He sent me an email saying that he's going to send hitmans after me. He's going to send Sidella. That's what he said. That's what Dark Side Phil said. Threatened my life.
Actually limiting it to only Japan actually is a good move, in my opinion, when you look at the scope of how YouTube works and everything. Only have it be a very much smaller, isolated group of content creators having this feature. Let them try it. Let them break it and figure out how it works. Let YouTube fix it before they roll it out to everyone. I would rather wait.
No, what the fuck?
Then have them flip a switch, and then people want to start gifting memberships. They try and it's not working, or oh well, people are getting memberships, but you don't get credit for them because the system's broken. You see, I'd much rather have them work on a smaller group like that. Have the
yeah, they would send Agent 47, but they're gonna send Derek, so it's gonna be Asian 47.
Content creators mess
47 IQ, I guess. Out.
And then have them roll it out to a wider group.
Okay. Yeah, now he understands this. But when they announced it that it's going to be 2022, oh my God, it needs to be now.
Okay, so I'm
right. Drop everything. Why do you have to pretend like you're TikTok with your shorts? Drop everything. Make pretend that you're Twitch. That's what you should do. These fucking. Oh my God. It's the same thing like with GTA. In the beginning, he jumps on a bandwagon immediately without thinking about anything. And then everyone makes their opinion and says it. And then he goes around and sees what's the general opinion and then agrees with it. Very nice.
And it's a good sign. If they're actually testing it for one group, that means they do have actually the intention of rolling it out for everyone and they're actually working on it. Wow,
yes.
An actual sign that YouTube's doing something useful in 2022. We have signs of life at Google, apparently. We've been looking for all last month and there was nothing. Okay, so that being said, I'm happy about this, and I hope that YouTube
maybe it's the VTubers.
Find stuff about this gifted membership practice with the Japanese content creators, and hopefully we will have some.
The VTubers are pushing society forward, dude.
I told you guys what I hope.
They're experimenting with the new technologies.
Was that this would actually be launched and in place by this month. I was hoping that with all the new release content coming out in the month of February, that this would be something that would be live for everyone by the end of February. If they're just entering the alpha stage for Japanese-only content creators,
yep.
I don't think that's going to happen. I think that this likely will be probably...
Bro, you have no idea. Like, you literally don't know. You just... why do you have an opinion on something you have no idea about?
Process to test out, and then they'll maybe do a soft launch.
But yeah.
At least it's a step in the right direction, okay?
Okay.
It's just unfortunate because I definitely have
to he's so fucking lame.
If it launched this month, it would benefit this channel tremendously with all the...
Yeah, I know. If somebody showed up and had $1 million, that would also benefit the channel tremendously, but that's not very likely to happen, is it?
I want to make a ginormous amount of money for no effort.
Obviously.
People are coming to DSP Gaming for the first time in years. Wow, Phil's playing... you know, the New Horizon. Phil's playing...
Gift itself is gonna be kinda like Twitch, except you gotta click on it in chat and accept it. So, I don't know. I guess it's gonna be similar.
Elden Ring. Very exciting. I'm gonna come watch Phil play this on his streams or whatever.
And very now, exciting.
In conjunction, right? In conjunction with that, increase in viewership and increase in attendance and increase in people watching... Now people say, oh, I'm going to help out Phil. Let me gift a bunch of memberships out. So now you have a newcomer who immediately was gifted a membership.
But why? That's what I'm confused about. Why? Why not just give him tips? They're going to help him the most. Why not just give him tips? Or a massive super chat, like $1,000. Why would giving him memberships be the specific thing? So he could do a feasting with the king and a shitty marathon? Really?
Wow.
Just give him the fucking money directly if you're this much of a pay pig. That you're gonna gift 1 million subs.
All these cool features.
I mean members.
To stick around, you see, it would help a lot. I get the feeling.
Why does it matter?
Tremendously, if it was in place, but no. Team.
No, it's a leg slapper instead.
Do it here. No, it's dependent on the region the content creator is in. So if I were registered as a Japanese content creator on the Japanese YouTube. Then,
oh, so if he scammed it, if he cheesed the system,
be eligible for having it, but being American and they know where I am and everything,
you can make a sock account.
Matter where you got
2014 Phil would have made a sock account and make it on Cat's name the AdSense and all that shit, he would hook it up so he could get monetized in Japan, so he could get 1 week ahead of gifted memberships. That's what he would do.
Guys are registered.
2014 DSP. And nowadays, DSP doesn't do shit. He's way too lazy. Just expects everybody else to do everything for him.
It matters where I'm registered. You see what I'm saying? So it would not work. We're actually talking
about... Yeah, he's gonna go with the VPN. He's gonna go in like an internet cafe to use a VPN PC or something.
He had mentioned that there's a secret feature on YouTube.
Secret feature.
Region listed, and by region listing, you get different features and things. He's right. If I was listed, I would have different features than being an American content creator, because in different countries in the world, certain things are legal, certain things aren't legal.
Yes.
So different agreements are in place. And so in Japan, they would have this, you see? It's kind of interesting. But the thing is, you don't have control over it. Like, I have no control over listing what region DSP Gaming is for. Likely, it's listed as a worldwide rather than, say, just a Japanese channel. And therefore, it has...
Bro, how long are you going to talk about this? What the fuck is wrong with you? Talk about something else. Fuck's sake.
Channel today? You know, the best way to support it is by tipping.
Okay, we know. We know. Do you need to say it like 10 years straight that we know? We know.
Need to pay. I really do need help with tips over this next coming weekend a lot.
Yeah, if he streams from an internet cafe, I would be interested in seeing a reality show arc, a season where he's basically like Ethan Ralph and having meltdowns and yelling at Medicare and calling him the N-word. That would be like a very entertaining series.
Much as you can. If you were thinking, oh, I want to support Phil, should I do a super
chat? I've never been thinking that. I've never, ever thought that. So, okay, let's skip that.
Tip, please tip this weekend. I need help with tips significantly.
It's my day off tomorrow. Come on. I need to pay $1 million bills.
Frequently. I really need that.
Why did I buy a yacht?
To pay bills and afford the games, okay?
Afford games. How have the mighty fallen? Can't even buy games anymore. Holy fuck, DSP. How did you get yourself here? How does this work? Let's proceed with the next one, which is... I don't know about this one. It's not very fun. The Dying Light slow premiere. And then after that, we get to the trolls. Which I'm gonna go actually watch the whole video. And then I'll go look up some clips.
This is how to play the game!
See you right now.
Sounds good to me.
That was the premiere stream of 64. Obviously wiping his tears after a slow day of tips.
I really would appreciate some help tonight.
I really would appreciate it if you shut the fuck up and get a job. I would appreciate it amazingly. So basically, the thing is that it's equally as important if I appreciate something than if DSP does. So DSP, I appreciate it if you get a job.
Single night this week.
It means the same amount.
Has been slow. And what I mean by that is we have not hit a tips goal.
Will I be watching the SOK video of Ex Mortis? You should go check it out first yourself. And then someday I'm going to watch it. I watched it yesterday. It's great. And it teaches you that if you want to troll DSP, you shouldn't take yourself way too seriously. And if you do, you're probably going to end up being like DSP or even funnier and cringier. Which, yeah. You don't want to do that. Probably.
$50 mark all week long. On the night streams, that is. And I don't know what it is, whether it's been Pokemon. One night we did... what did we do in the middle? I can't even remember what we did. But basically,
and also, Ex Mortis yesterday played Sifu. Because he got the deluxe edition. And that game is tough as fuck, but it looks great. The combat, when you get into like a sequence of fighting a couple of enemies and you don't miss, is just godlike. It's so badass.
Everything I've been doing on the night streams just isn't really coming together, and I don't know why. And it's frustrating because we're having good times. It seems like everyone enjoys the late streams. Like, they're more chill. There's a lot of interactivity. It's cool when you don't have to try to make major progress in a game, which is usually the case with these night streams. Okay. So, yeah, I'm basically trying to make up for that, and I don't know how I'm going to. Like earlier today, the premiere of Dying Light 2.
I don't expect him to get absolutely destroyed by the game today, but as it goes on, it gets harder and it's gonna spread its cheeks.
Much higher viewership than I
probably today is gonna be okay. You're probably gonna be underwhelmed.
Usually have on a day stream. Actually, ridiculous amounts of engagement. We have over 200 likes on the stream.
Ridiculous amounts of engagement.
I was like, wow. And it's one thing if you get one slow day, two slow days, three slow days. We're going now on four straight slow days this week.
Four slow days. And then the trolls, literally after this bitching segment, this clownery of Dying Light, the trolls, those human garbage pieces of shit mentally ill that the white coats should come for them, they showed up. How dare they show up and mock Phil for pleading for support on a slow premiere day stream. So sad. How could they do this? All he's doing is just begging.
I actually have a significantly large amount of bills to pay next week.
Oh, significantly large amount of bills. It sounds good.
So tonight, if you are going to contribute, thank you. If you have the choice of how to contribute,
what if I don't want to?
Please tip me. All right, it would be stupendous if we could hit the goals tonight.
Please tip me.
Well, everyone's saying they want M. Bison. Please contribute. Come on, guys.
This shit is sad.
Can do anything.
And then he plays Street Fighter and some pay pig showed up and everything was okay. I think Jax Raxer showed up or some other cuck.
Times in a row, I'm playing people.
And now we skip through the gameplay because that's not what's important about this reality show. I think it's here in the end. He says something dumb.
Give you the block because of the lag. That's incredibly bad gameplay.
And then after this video, I'm actually going to go and check the actual clip.
All you can taste is
from Hate Army Watch, I think.
So thank you, Dan the Man, for that tip. With Dan the Man's tip, we're now at 126, guys. We are so close to the tip's goal.
Yeah. And then, now, I actually omitted to say this about this stream. During the night shift, he made a lot of money. So the premiere was terrible, and then he begged a lot, and the trolls mocked him. And then people came back to support and rallied all of the pay pigs. It was the march of the pay pigs. And then we're going to segue into the next video where everybody, quote unquote, was mad. And they were thinking only about how much money DSP is making, which is none of our business. Except for all the times where it is. And we need to make that number get bigger.
$31 tip, and yes, that will be the top tip of the night.
Epic.
We have hit the tip's goal for tonight. We actually are at 158 now, I believe, if I did the math correctly there.
I've never run into this thing before. What is it, a money creature? Yeah, look, it's a money creature. It just throws money around. Dark side, Phil. What the hell was that?
I'm lurking.
That sucks.
And some more Street Fighter gameplay we're gonna skip, but here it is. The pay pig. The pay pig showed up 158. It's very positive. Very interactive as well. It's a big number. It interacts a lot. Now let's go to Hate Army Watch and see. There's two videos that I really enjoy, which is DSP admits the trolls are getting more engagement than him, which means we drink more Kool-Aid than he does, than his pay pigs. Now we have a DSP has not had a stroke, which is a very cool video, which might be one of the first ones we watched. Snowcarl came back. Dire warning message to retractors. Oh, this shit happened as well. Oh, there's so much shit that happened. DSP is accused of over-explaining things. For those who don't know, yeah, there was a massive compilation of this. And then the trolls dancing on his Dying Light channel. It was great. Let's dive in. Hey, Kate Army Watch is here. Big ups. Now, I don't know which one is gonna be the funniest. Let's start with the shortest one, with the stroke. Oh, and then the retractor ones we're gonna see. He was so fucking salty, his chat was clowning on him. And he couldn't even tell what they said.
$1.50. He said, I put my headphones on, now no one but me can hear your voice. I did get a few comments from people because of your mouth. There you go.
Oh yeah, that's what we just saw in the Snort Burnell.
Oddly deformed or shaped. Oh, come on. Listen, when I was young, my friends, yes, my friends called me Phil with the oddly shaped head. I'm not ashamed to admit this.
Yeah, we got this again.
It's very weirdly shaped. What's wrong with my lips? Come on.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I didn't have a stroke, guys. I promise.
What's wrong my lips?
Your left side looks like it doesn't move.
The left side of my mouth.
Now, there's, in the last couple days, he looks like just so bizarre, man. When he talks, it's almost like his lips don't move at all.
So bizarre.
The left side of my...
And he's clowning like this for nonsense. Why is he even doing this? Is this supposed to be a part of the podcast? This is supposed to be a part of a podcast. So I'm going to pop this on Spotify, listen to it, enjoy it, and then he's going to talk about his mouth.
Looks, which side? This side or this
side? This side. I can't tell. I'm listening.
See this. I have to turn my head. It sucks. I can't see it straight forward. My mouth is moving.
Okay. I can't see it. I'm listening. It's the guy. I'm listening to his Spotify podcast.
I'm kind of looking over there at the television screen.
I'm kidding. It's not a real podcast, obviously. But yeah, he did have a stroke, 100%. Just trust me and drink the Kool-Aid. Sounds good? A troll outro. We saw that. That was fantastic. Yeah, here is the retractors. He's going to time out all of you, and you're going to go outside to think about what you've done. Don't talk about music, sports, or religion, or politics, dude. How dare you?
One other thing. Last couple of days, for some odd reason, there's a running theme in stream chat.
There's a running theme.
That sometimes, I guess, are insulting, and sometimes they're not. They're just silly. But then they're pulling back their messages. It's called redacting a message. You can remove your own message.
Pulling back.
YouTube stream chat.
Your dad should have redacted his penne.
You can mess around with this as much as you want.
There's been a penne retracted.
Going in there and saying insulting things and then pulling the messages so no one can see them. And then on top of that, people are like, dude, the entire chat is just redacted comments because people think it's funny. It's not. It's stupid. It's immature. It's annoying. So it's this simple. You want to do it. It's a feature here on YouTube. Big deal. But if I see it in excess, I am going to start timing people out. Like, if I see it once,
nobody can have any amount of fun. You're not allowed. This is not for fun. This is for re. It's not for fun. It's not for games. It's not for chill. It's not allowed. It's banned. This is North Korea. Everything is fake as fuck. Everything is made out of plastic. Big ups Paul J. Bradlow for the $2 super chat. It's like they put Botox in the wrong place. It's like he put the Botox on himself.
Twice big deal.
That's why how he looks. He's so bloated and just like the balloon filled with piss.
Like entire screen of redacted. I'm just going to say timeout.
It's North Korea.
Banned. Gone.
This clip is fantastic with this fucking vest and this hat and these glasses and this bald spot on the goatee. Beautiful. And what is this, a Bowser shirt? A Yoshi shirt? Yeah, that's Yoshi.
Forever.
And fuck, I got all the stream chat, all the facts.
Tut, it's going to be ban, and then we're going to continue
Stop
on.
Stop having like, fun. What the fuck?
You know, so do all I'll say is this. Do it at your own discretion.
But man, is it... accidents happen, man. Accidents happen. I don't know. You should watch out. If you want to retract messages, watch out.
Stupid.
I'm not saying somebody's going to come to your home, break down your door, break your kneecaps, tie you up to a chair, and make you listen to some DSP podcast. I'm not saying that, but shit happens, man. You never know.
Yes, it can be derailing and
distracting. Lock the door.
In the chat. So... if you keep doing it, I'm just going to time you out, and you're going to have to wait to talk again. You're going
to
look
stupid,
aren't you?
You have to wait. Yeah, you're going to look stupid.
Do it at your own discretion.
You're going to look real stupid. Yeah, this guy that's complaining about it, he looks real smart. He is so smart the way that he fucking gets enraged as people having fun in his chat. But no, you're going to look stupid for triggering him. And pissing him off. You're going to look so dumb. Please don't do this. So
I hope you're listening.
I hope you're listening.
Because if I see it and it's annoying, I'm just going to time you right.
There's no retracting in my class. Get out of my fucking class. Wait outside. Think about what you've done. And when you come back, you're going to apologize and tell me you will never retract your messages again. You understand, Timmy?
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
Thank you, Timmy.
Right out. And I'm gonna advise all the moderators to do exactly the same thing. That if I see it and it's annoying, I'm going to have you timed out. Okay? Fair enough?
You're going to wait outside the stream. He's going to make you close the tab until you can come back. You're going to be banned from watching the stream.
Watch this.
This is the best. Phenomenal content. And he's gone. He's on the phone. It's phone time.
Dark side Phil's erroneous use of tips and bits to fund his addiction to
my
wrestling pixels.
Right now.
What? He's texting the mods in the secret Discord. I'm texting my moderators right now. Do you think this makes you look tough? And we can all see your bald spot. Good fucking job, Dave. You made yourself look like a clown yet again. You didn't need anybody's help to make yourself look like a joke. The guy. I'm watching. I'm not even sure what I'm watching. He's getting cucked by people that are writing in his chat, literally.
Fuck life, 100%. Live the life of the cuck. Why not? Burn on the oven.
Not gonna let this go raw, but he's still like, how long is it taking you to text the fucking in Discord? What a fucking idiot, man.
You see someone abusing the message redacted feature of YouTube chat to time the person out.
They're abusing the feature.
Don't abuse it. I don't care if you do it every once in a while. Oh, it's hilarious every once in a while. But if I didn't see people abusing it over and over, you're right.
These contributions are mandatory.
Let's go on to the next one, and this is the big one. This is it's the blue whale of DSP videos, I guess. There's like 40 minutes of a insane spiral of nonsense and clown mode and arrogance and just absolute wheelchair activity. Absolute. Let's go. I've seen this probably 4 times by now on different people's streams.
Okay. Now, attendance was great.
Attendance was great. Let's start with that.
We had probably around 400 on average, 400 viewers, and it went up and down during the course of the stream, but it went pretty well. I would argue discoverability was great because I had over 200 likes on yesterday's stream, which pushed me into the rankings, and people were saying I was like top 5.
All right, I'll be right back. You listen to this preface.
The game on YouTube, which is excellent. Not to say that means anything, because
I'm gonna go get some water and shit.
For games streamed on YouTube, not a lot of people. This isn't Twitch, but still, it's good to know that I was in the top viewed group, right? Now, let's talk about support, okay? Because this seems to be the heavy area of contention, and I hate to say it, but this should not be a factor at all. Yet, for some odd reason, there's obsessive people out there that they think this is their business. And they made it like the obsessive focus of the stream. All right. So I'm streaming Dying Light 2. I'm enjoying it. I'm getting through the tutorial stages, the intro or whatever. And admittedly, support with tips wasn't astronomically good. Actually, with Super Chats, it was quite good for a stream. I think we were at, you know, I don't even know exactly off the top of my head, but I know we were above $50 in Super Chats. So it was good. And plus we had members too. Like I told you guys, we had hit a new record for members, 359. So I know overall the stream was successful. The stream went good. All right. Now, I guess what it is that we have this artificial expectation that whenever I'm playing a brand new game, especially a game that's maybe hyped and or people are wondering if it's any good, that I'm going to get an overabundance of support on that particular stream. Okay. In general, I would argue that.
All right, I'm back.
Statement. If you're here for a big new release and attendance is higher than a standard stream, typically support comes
attendance with, talk.
Okay.
And typically, I hope you clocked in. Here,
yes.
Otherwise, the system is going to get mad.
I would probably
if you don't clock in and you're on a shift.
A lot of tip support on a stream. As you know, I have goals on my streams. If I raise $50 in tips, I do a reward goal of putting on Gunner glasses. If I raise $100 in tips, you guys get to vote on a hat for me to wear. And if I do the full tips goal of $150, you vote on a vest for me to wear for said stream. Okay. Cool. I get it. Makes sense. So people are expecting that on a first stream. Okay. Guess what? It didn't happen. I played the first.
Some people are expecting that. Who? You? You? You were expecting that. Because when you're a streamer, you shouldn't be expecting that. And it's your job that this is your job. I mean, it's your fault.
$50 in tips or something like that. So yeah. I went on break. I came back.
No, hate Army Watch. If you want to clock in, you got to stay here. If you close the tab, you need to clock out.
More tips got us above 50.
I need to put some chat commands like that.
Stream, we're only at like $60 in tips. Okay, now is this the end of the world? Absolutely not. Is it disheartening? Well, makes me wonder, is this a game that's not very entertaining for my audience? That because in general, the rule of thumb that I use is thus. Okay,
what if you don't make money, game goes bye bye.
I'm the rule of thumb. Entertaining stream, and that could mean any of a million things. It could mean that I particularly am entertaining during a stream for whatever reason.
Okay, it's thus.
Maybe the way I'm acting, the gameplay I'm putting in.
All right.
Maybe the game itself is entertaining, right? And you guys are enjoying just the game in general, and experiencing it with me. Maybe it's a combination. Maybe it's me and my commentary and my gameplay combining with the great game. Or on the flip side of that, there could just be a stream that it's just really great interactions between us. We're talking.
When? Because that happened.
A lot of fun.
When?
Interactions.
How?
That's what I would call
more like what?
Late night chill stream. Usually.
Like what? Like what? Interactive chill streams. This fucking, this shitty marketing scheme for people that, I don't know, he thinks that, I don't fucking know, man. I don't know. Who are you trying to sell this to? You're trying to tell them how they feel. Wow, you come here and you love this so much. And that means that you give me a lot of money.
Kind of streams that are like that.
And he's building into it. He's building into the reasons why you support him, right? Because this, we need to analyze this madman. He needs to be micro-analyzed, as he likes to say. So here in the beginning, he's going to try and tell you when you usually give him money. When you have a lot of fun, when we have a lot of interactions, that's when you give him a lot of money.
So,
okay? So.
Yes, in general, my rule of thumb is, have your stream be entertaining for
whatever. Hey, what's up, Mr. Sam? How's it going?
It's going to naturally come. Okay?
Support's going to naturally come. What is natural?
My deal. I don't want to sit here and advertise to you constantly and say,
that's
hey,
what you do.
Do this, do that, pay, you know.
Literally every day.
Support this way, support that way. Do this, do this. I just want to have a fun stream.
Oh.
In general, if you
well,
have
then fun, just, I don't know, just get a job. And you can have a fun stream and not care about how much money you make. Truly not care.
Where
come on.
We hit goals and stuff. I never mention it again. Once
I never mention it again. Yeah, because you, like, what? Because then it's literally greed. What? So he's flexing that he doesn't beg when he reaches his maximum goal of $150 a stream. Of course you're not gonna beg. Of course you're not gonna beg. Should I be thankful that you don't beg after you get what you beg for?
So now,
what is the semantics of this?
You see?
I only beg for 150, man. Well, good job for you.
Yesterday.
What?
I was basically really focused on the game because I was interested in the intro segment. Did I mention a few times, hey, you can contribute by doing this or that? Yes, a few times.
DSP is not fit to get a job that gets as much money. Well, that's his own business. That's his own business. Why would he put himself in a situation like this when no job can make him any amount of money?
I was just enjoying myself.
That is meaningful.
And by the end of the stream, the last like half hour, the actual main discussion of the people in the chat itself.
Well, the chat was talking about it.
Why were contributions so low this stream?
Because you talk about it. Because you bring it up so much that it's absorbed what your stream is supposed to be. And it's given it a completely different appearance. And people are watching it for a completely different reason. There are so many people that I think watching him just to see how much money he's gonna get. They don't care about the fucking gameplay. They don't care about the pre-stream. Let's see how much money he's gonna get and how much he's gonna beg. That's the reason why they watch him. It's not for the fucking meaningful interactions. And I would even say his fans as well. And probably watch him out of habit. Because just, if he streams every day, you're gonna get used to watching him every day.
And I'm like, you know, is it true that contributions were on the slower side compared to what would be a typical new release? Yes.
Yes.
I don't necessarily want to fucking talk about it during
well, you did.
The gameplay of the new release.
Let's see when he talked about it. Okay? That sounds fair to me. Let me take a look if he... wait, this doesn't have gameplay. Snort Burnell, maybe? He had it, right? I think so. I'm gonna find it and see exactly when he begged. Here it is, somewhere here. What? Dying Light slow premiere? This starts here. First, we got Street Fighter. We got just Street Fighter. I'm confused. Is this... oh, yeah. Here it is.
Every single night this week. Every night.
And this was Dying Light. The game is still on the screen. But this probably after the stream, right in the end. It was a slow day. And also, if I was... super a lot of an asshole, I would look up PicPicGo for slow stream or slow, and then I would probably find him talking about it during the game.
But I don't want to bother right
no,
now.
No, not really. If I wanted to, I would. You see? But what was happening was people were actually in the actual chat of the stream itself, turning the stream into, why is this number so low today?
I will tell you why. I will tell you why. Because you put the responsibility for making that number big on them. Sounds good? That's exactly why. So they're dented enough and they're wheelchaired enough that this is how they're gonna think. Man, how can I help Phil without giving him money to make this tips goal so big? I'm gonna raise awareness to it. Man, Phil's tips are really low today. You guys should support. And then of course the trolls join in and they ironically support and say, man, Phil, I wish people would send you more money, man. I feel bad for you. And then he looks at those comments and this is what you get. This is the rant that you get.
And that's not cool.
That's not cool. Talk about that. All right.
That's my.
If you want to beg, that's okay. If anybody wants to beg on your behalf, then that's not cool.
It's my stream. It's my business. But it shouldn't be up to anyone else taking it upon themselves to say,
listen. Hey, what's up, Kid Flim?
The entirety of the chat.
We're sticking it to him, man. We're sticking it to
that
him.
That number is important to me.
Yeah.
But it doesn't matter if that number is zero. 150 or whatever.
No, it literally does.
Is still the stream. The stream
it's not. It's not because if it's a slow day with like $10, he's going to be talking about it every 20 minutes and pausing the game and talking about how it's his day off tomorrow, has to pay an enormous amount of thousands of millions of bills, and has to spend a bunch of money on booze and on mobile games. Except that part he doesn't tell you. Just the bills.
And the stream is not going to,
you don't need to know that. That's none of your business. You shouldn't be asking about it. Just give money and drink the Kool-Aid on your way out. When you clock out, take a sip and go home.
Just because.
And come back tomorrow at the same time. We have a tips goal to make go big.
This number wasn't hit. Doesn't mean that the stream was bad.
Yeah, it does.
That's what people were acting like.
But hold on. He just said that when he does a good stream, the number is big. And now he's saying that just because the number was small doesn't mean that it wasn't a good stream. But by his definition, it was.
Like, seriously, like...
He just said it, like, 2 minutes ago.
By the end of that stream, people were like, wow.
Oh, yeah, and he was begging tweets during the stream, which is, yeah.
Wow, Phil. Your tip support
was wow, Phil. Today.
And I'm like, and?
And?
Like, and what?
You beg every day. Why are you surprised? You literally make it all about tips. It's the tips show.
So big deal.
With Darkside you know, Phil, the guy.
Over the years, especially now that I'm a
it's the tips show. Yeah. And there's like laugh tracks on it and applauses. When he walks in the room, there's a massive applause.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking.
I'm lurking, I'm stalking. When you least expect it. I'm going to tip when you least expect it.
When you're crowdfunded, okay?
Crowdfunded.
There's some time.
Put so much prestige on being an actual bum. So much prestige. Homeless king.
Think things are going to go amazingly positive, and they don't. There's times when you'll think absolutely nothing. Oh, this is going to be a typical stream, no big deal. And then all of a sudden...
And then he jerks off.
Out of nowhere. And you're like, wow.
He jerks off out of nowhere. Oh my god, he's pulling his cock out.
Blown away with the positivity and the support.
Yeah,
and
you're blown away. Right? And then you're on drama alert.
And this happens all the time. This isn't just like every once in a while. I'm constantly... not knowing what's going to happen on a stream. I think that's actually part of the real cool thing about being a streamer like this and being a crowdfunded individual.
Crowdfunded individual.
Volatility to it.
Volatility. Okay. How is this good? How is this good? How is this good? That there's a volatility to it.
And that volatility...
How? How is this good? That today you can get $200 because 1 minute, man, and only iced coffee and Jack's Raxer showed up and all dropped like 25. And then you got a bunch of other money. And then the other day you can get 10 bucks. What?
Actually.
Come on. I get it. It's unpredictable. Anything can happen during a live stream. And you can get a lot of money or you can get not a lot of money. But I wouldn't say that's... if that's your job, being volatile like that, I wouldn't say that's the good thing or the interesting thing. But it kind of feels like gambling, huh? It kind of feels like gambling, except you get to beg. And when you beg, the chances of winning get more.
Is a thing that is
sounds
exciting.
Good.
You never know if you're going to have a stream where, oh my God, there's so much support, or there's like no support and it goes back.
Okay, starting the podcast, I'm not going to be watching that right now.
Back and forth.
No way, because it's going to kill my entire vibe because I need to listen to him live.
Obviously, where it comes into a concern.
Frog is watching him live. You can go check him out.
For me, is if I'm doing a whole streaming week and in general, it's slow almost every day. And I'll give you an example. This particular week, okay, there were several streams where we were not hitting anything past the initial.
Yeah, you begged. Even though that is wrong. He hit the... Yeah, it's not wrong.
Now,
he hit the 50.
I've tried...
But in a different clip, he says this week he didn't hit it,
to explain
which this, was a lie.
In a nutshell, I'll try to say it again. Last year, I lost my Twitch partnership for completely invalid reasons. Okay, unjustifiable. I was mistreated by the company. That's why I'm not going back. They can go to hell for all I care. Okay?
They can go to hell.
Since then, I've been trying.
Oh, today he's gonna talk about his day off, which I'm not interested at all. But if somebody tells me that he's ranting about something or something catastrophic will happen, I might check him out.
Recover. But I had a certain level.
If he, I don't know, says he has like he's pregnant or something.
Level of income that I was making on Twitch because of the level of subscribers and cheers that I was getting over there. The day that I went from Twitch to YouTube, that went way down. And I've been trying ever since then to catch back up to where I was on Twitch. It's been almost a year, and I'm not even close. I have 357 members. I had more than double that on Twitch.
He's showing the wrong thing. He's showing the super chats.
On YouTube, okay? So there's a lot of lost...
There's a lot of lost judgment.
That I have to deal with, and that's why I've been telling you guys...
Yeah, but...
Your financially things have been tight.
But wasn't the volatility a great thing?
Where a lot of
it's a great thing that a week I might not make any money. That's fantastic.
Tips to tips.
I live for that.
Bills and things. That's just how it is right now. Eventually things will get better, but kind of stuck right now with how things are. That's why I'm trying to build
it's up. It's been tough.
Rebrand DSP Gaming this
rebrand.
Year.
Rebrand. How rebrand like what? What is rebranding? What does it mean? Because when a company rebrands, it's usually a process that just kind of happens within a pretty short amount of time, I guess, but you have all your assets for rebranding in advance. So you prepare all your logos and your graphic packages, and you look up all the places where you need to change your name or whatever. And he's not rebranding anything. It's still the same shit. It's still DSP Gaming. It's just a different icon that the color palette on that doesn't match anything on his stream, and his pre-stream podcast layout doesn't match anything else. And he's using some default template for frames and cameras and stuff like that. He's still DSP. Nothing is rebranded. Nothing.
All these things different.
Still the same shit. He called his pre-stream a podcast, which is now nothing. And by calling it a podcast, he motivated himself to spew even more bullshit and garbage daily. So, yeah.
Okay. Now. This week, in particular, there were several streams where I wasn't hitting the tips goals. And let me tell you guys something.
Several slow days.
Tips goals is actually scary. Because
yeah, and just like I told you, the people that make fun of him, aka I'm a part of those people, obviously, posted on Twitter, oh my God, he's begging a lot. He's actually begging.
The bill's coming up to pay, and I got to buy all these games this month. It's
well, that's too bad.
Busy.
I forgot the part where that's my responsibility.
Release month, okay? And I'm looking
at like,
wow, this pattern. It's one thing if you have one slow day, two slow days, but it's like, wow, 3-4 days in a row. The night stream.
Yeah, man, you're falling off. You're falling off.
I'm getting not a lot of support.
Because it's like those people that give him money daily, I don't know what their end game is. For example, 1 minute man. Like, bro. Do you see this guy has no intention of changing anything? So he is now officially dependent on you daily for your 25. And when he doesn't get it, he gets all pissy and shit. Because the tips goal is going to be with 25 less. So that's my question to dudes like the 1 minute man. Is what is your why? And how long? You're going to give him $25 every day? He has no intention of doing anything.
At all.
So you're just giving it and it just exists. It doesn't go towards anything. You're never gonna see him improve in the way that you mean to support him. You're just supporting him for him to just blow it away.
The day streams,
I don't know, I'm so confused. Skyrim. There's no like strategy. There's nothing. Because, like, you see him claim to want to get bigger and attract more people and whatever, get more engagement. But, man, people aren't fucking brainless. They aren't mindless. They're going to see it sucks. They're going to go watch the Rad Brad or somebody else, like MK Ice and Fire or whatever, the guy making all the 4K playthroughs. There's just a walkthrough of the game with no commentary and stuff. People, that's what they're going to go watch, the main guys. They're not going to stick around for Phil, no matter how many comments you leave for him or how many likes.
Doing all right.
Because they're fake likes. They're not genuine.
But it's like, wow, I'm not hitting any maximized goals at all.
Maximized goals. Now we're a business. Now we're talking like a business.
And when I set these goals into place...
This business is about to have a 40-minute monologue about haters and people that are mad at him making money and happy when he doesn't make money. This is the business we're talking about.
Okay. The reason I designed them the way I did was that there's a little bit of leeway, but in general, if I'm hitting the goals, you know, every few streams, it's good and I'm making ends meet. All right. But when there's several days where I'm not hitting any of these goals, that means I'm not making enough money to pay anything.
Yeah, that's what it means. You don't need to have a business degree and explain this in such detail. We know what it means.
So it's like day after...
When money is not big, then happy is small.
Day after day, it's this hard.
Sound good?
Oh, crap, this is scary. I don't know what's going to happen now.
Yeah, you're going to get a job.
With income this week, for some odd reason, it's down. Okay? And there's various reasons why it could happen. And I'm not going to sit here and say the sky is falling like Chicken Little and freak out.
What are the various reasons? Explain to me all the various reasons. People didn't like it. It wasn't funny enough. It wasn't fun enough, entertaining enough, chill enough. I don't know. They maybe didn't have time. Maybe they didn't care. Because that's... You forget about this. You forget about this. Why do you feel entitled that people care about this stream? Sometimes they might not care. And that's completely their right.
Positively, and hopefully things get
maybe
better.
They just don't give a fuck about part 5 of Dying Light or part 1. Maybe right. they don't care. Maybe they're gonna go watch somebody else, and that's perfectly okay.
So the Dying Light 2 stream happened yesterday
because it's YouTube, man. Come on.
And I only
you're not entitled to people caring.
It's like $60 on the stream, which is a big premiere stream. Okay, now am I gonna freak out and go crazy and go nuts? No. But
most of the time,
this group of people are.
Oh, okay. Now we segue into the group of people that they started off in his chat, but now they're everywhere, all over the internet.
Because I'm not kidding.
From a farm in New Zealand to Twitter to YouTube to Facebook to Google Plus to MySpace, everywhere. We are everywhere, taken over.
Kidding you.
I'm not
the
kidding you.
The major discussion that I've seen.
The major discussion
about people. On the internet about my Dying Light 2.
Where? How? What is the discussion? Where do you see those people? Why aren't they blocked? Where did you see this? The major... Look at just the phrasing. And I told you, we're gonna go deep in this because this needs to be nitpicked to hell. The major discussion of people on the internet. Where? On Kiwi Farms? They have major discussions about everything. They talk about everything. And I post there and I know. They gossip about everything. On Twitter? Of course. Josh Poems is gonna post about it. A bunch of other people are gonna post about it. Goutside Phil is gonna post about it. Bill Fernell is gonna post about it. I'm gonna post about it if it's a slow stream. When I wake up in the morning and I see, my god, the dude made $40 on the night stream, I'm gonna post it, and I'm gonna post some cringe face picture of DSP, some meme. I'm gonna troll on him, dank on him. You know?
Premiere stream was not the game.
Where did he see those people? How did he find them? Did he go out of his way to read Kiwi Farms?
Game, the content of the game, the content of my commentary, the attendance, the viewership.
Because it's all ass. Because it's all ass, and it takes a backseat to tips. By his own words, because that's how he treats it. That's what the priority is. Tips have the highest priority.
Engagement, the fact that I was in the top 5 people streaming the game on YouTube. None of that.
Okay,
all
who cares?
Oh.
You're in the top 5 and you flop. You literally were in the top 5 and you flop. So what? Why would people discuss that? Would you like people to discuss that? That you were in top 5 and had a major disappointing night? Oh my god, Phil was in top 5 and he made only $43 in tips. What a fucking loser.
Did you hear that?
Did
Phil,
you hear?
He only made $60.
Who said
wow,
this? Did they say this on DSPGaming.com, that shitty forum that collects your IP?
For a huge big release stream.
And gives it to weird perverts?
Okay. What the fuck are you talking about? No, really. Number one, how the fuck is it your business?
You make it my business, and I am a viewer of yours. Yes, I don't like you. I'm watching the reality show, not the gameplay. The gameplay is garbage. At points, if there's some highlights, I might see them, but the gameplay is garbage. I'm here for the reality show, and the reality show is pretty good. And this is how it's my business. It's my business to discuss it because it's fun, and I want to make it my business because you try and make it my business too. Because as a viewer, you try and put the responsibility on me and people like me that watch you every day or most days, and they have to pay your bills and they have to support you. And yeah, that kind of sounds good.
It's my stream. It's my business.
It's not my business. Then make the money yourself. Why are you begging? If it's not my business.
Who cares how much money I make?
Yeah, that's true. He's asking. He's asking for tips and tweets.
King stream. How is that your
business? How is it my business? You make it my business.
Be all of what I'm doing.
Just like it was my business to look at the leaks when they happened, because it was my business that his fucking bills need to be paid and he was begging for them, and then it turned out that he was spending that money on DoorDash and Total Wine and PayPal transactions of thousands of dollars.
How many times a year do I stream? All right?
A lot.
Twice a day. How many days a year? One day a week. I'm also 300 days a year. So
364 outside of the day off
in a year.
Imagine if he had one day off a year. That's actually working his ass off.
Oh no, I had a slow one. Oh, I'm scared now. You know what I'm saying? Like, what are you talking about?
But bro, that's literally, this has happened before. And last time he hyped it up on Twitter, though, and I made a stream about it, watching it, and I was super disappointed because it sucked. But he was foreshadowing it on Twitter, and he said that he's going to have a very mature and intelligent discussion about the future of the streams. And the whole discussion was basically a coping session for himself for not having a lot of tips for literally one day. That was it. I think he failed both goals or something like that. It was just, you know, your average DSP begging. But he decided, because people made fun of him, he decided to make the state of the stream address. And yeah, it was terrible. So it was basically the sky is not falling, the stream. So yeah, pretty cringe. So this has happened before, but now it's more toxic.
And then on top of that,
because it obviously is.
I know. There's a large group of people on the internet.
A large group of people.
It's called hate following me. Okay? What does it mean? It means that for whatever...
We know what does it mean. You don't need to explain it. But he needs to explain it because he wants to frame it in a way that he wants to frame it. So pay attention.
Various reasons. They don't
various like reasons. They don't like me. I can't understand what the reason can be.
That they just don't like me and my personality.
That's
they
true.
Feel that I don't put out quality content and I don't deserve success.
That's true.
That maybe over the years I've been dishonest with my audience and they don't like that.
That's
and
true.
Some of them actually have a bug up their ass about things.
It's very funny how the first three things he can think of are absolutely true. They're 100%. And he realizes it, so that's what he brings up.
Is that it happened
to very nice, DSU.
Who knows?
I like the shred of self-awareness.
But there is a group out there that literally hate follows me, all right? The only reason that they're following me on the internet is to shit on me and
Yeah, it's so fun. Haven't you done this with a reality show? Haven't you watched the Love Island or fucking the Circle or what was it? Too Hot to Handle? All these stupid shows that you just sit there and make fun of because they're funny. This is the same shit. Except that it's a little bit less scripted. A little bit.
Doesn't matter if I do 10 things right. The one thing that I do wrong is the thing that they focus on and talk about. It doesn't matter.
Well, it's funny, yeah.
I had an insanely great January, which I did. A month when there was
insanely
like
great
going on for new releases.
All
right. Right? Nothing. I still had a great streaming month. Everything was good. Engagement was up. It was a
engagement
miracle that
was
I
up.
Actually did as well as I did in January, because typically January is my slowest month of the year. In reality, it was a really good month for me, right? Ignore that. Phil had a bad stream of Dying Light 2 when it comes to tips raised. Not even overall, because overall...
Not even overall.
Viewership was good, engagement was good. I was discovered on YouTube and got a bunch of new subs.
I got discovered on YouTube. Chats were good. What is this delusion, bro? Viewerships were good. I love it when he hypes himself up like that. I love it. It's one of my favorite things about him as a reality show viewer is when he hypes himself up, when he makes him like makes himself really hyped up for success and for just progress, and it's really fucking fun. I love it.
Only thing you can even argue.
Oh, you can argue.
On the slow side.
Was the tips. All right?
Was the
they're
tip.
The most important
That's
thing.
The only
Come on.
Thing you could say was a negative.
Don't say they're not.
But this is what these fucking people
they are.
All right? They are hate followers. They.
Oh, he's starting up the Sifu stream? Wait, the game's not starting yet.
They literally follow things on the internet just to hate and crap on them.
All yeah. Right?
That is probably one of the most broken.
Why?
Existences.
The I broken think. Existences. And now, here he makes a couple of implications, which the main one is that we dedicate our entire existence to hating Phil. Now, he as a narcissist, of course he wants to believe this. That makes him very flattered and makes him very, I guess, happy in some way, that we give him all this attention. Of course, it's not the attention he wants, which is absolutely positive and unconditionally positive, but it's something, so he still a little bit values it, I guess. And, yeah, it's kind of bullshit. He assumes that we just dedicate our whole existence to this just because his whole existence is dedicated to making shitty streams. Because outside of those streams, he does nothing. So it's literally the same argument you can make for him, but the opposite thing. You dedicate yourself to making literal garbage content every day without any progress, any progression, any development. Why? That is a sick, fucked in the head mindset, DSP.
I can even imagine. Can you imagine that all you did was...
And of course, he's grandstanding because he's by default superior than this group of people who don't like him and say, hey, DSP, you suck, you beg, you're lame.
Your life.
And he equates those people that just say, hey, DSP made $40 today. That's kind of funny because he's a shitty streamer and shouldn't make a lot of money. And when they tweet this out and it gets 2 likes, they're equated to the same people that are watching DSP every day, like me, and that fucking, I don't know, make videos about him and try and troll him with songs. Which is funny. I do it because it's funny and it's really entertaining for me. It's number one, it's for me entertaining, and number two, it's entertaining for other people. And in the end, the third reason is that in some way, somebody might use it to troll him and it's funny. Like they put the Kanye song in the outro.
Things you dislike?
Because it's funny.
Like, instead of actually having... Oh,
yeah,
I like this.
It's funny.
I follow it, and I celebrate it.
I also follow and celebrate a lot of stuff that I like. If you join my Discord, you'll know. Because then we talk about games and TVs and stuff.
And I there's a fan...
So yeah, you'll see what we do outside of the time we harass and destroy Phil. Hello, Renee. What's up?
For it, and I interact with that fan base, and I have a good time, and we all have positivity around this stuff that we like.
Yeah, that's a good logic in chat. I agree with you, David. Your life revolves around that TV show you watch after work for 30 minutes. It basically that kind of logic, because there's so many people that just watch a Snort Burnell, and then they're like, "Wow, DSP, that guy's fucking lame," and that's it. But they get equated to people that follow him around and fucking dox him or something.
You do the opposite. Focus in on people who hate something and you become a hate focus group.
Hate focus group. No, he's using the term focus group wrong.
All you do is crap on something and you revel in bringing down the thing you don't like. Can you see the difference? It's called being productive versus being destructive.
But Phil, this is also productive. These videos are productive that exist. By Hate Army Watch, it's productive because it, I don't know, people watched it instead of watching the pre-stream podcast that sucks. And I'm watching it right now, so I think it's pretty productive. And I'm producing a stream right now. How is DSP productive? He produces a bunch of generic shitty videos. And according to YouTube, which is the site that he does his job on, we are more productive than he is. because every one of us gets better engagement than he does. So what does that mean for Phil?
Being positive versus being negative. Actually building something up and having something good in your life versus trying to constantly bring down things that you think are bad in life. Like, listen to me. I understand that there are times in life when you feel like I gotta take a stand again.
Oh, and now we get the dad talk. Now we get the lecture. But let me tell you, you shouldn't be hating me. Instead, I'm gonna tell you how to live your life. Sounds good?
I gotta rally for a cause.
DSP, you have no right to be giving anybody advice on anything, man. Come on. You were trolling people on internet forums, and then they wanted to beat you up in real life, and you cried. Don't be giving me these fucking, these moralist talks and lectures after 14 years of literal failure in racism and hateful slurs and homophobic slurs and all this bullshit. Don't be giving me these talks. They don't work. They don't work because you're sitting on a tips goal. That's the fucking thing he's sitting on. There's a tips goal there that determines his life that is completely influenced by random people on the internet.
We gotta stop.
So don't give me these fucking talks.
Something that's an injustice to the planet.
You're a reality show, Phil. You're a reality show.
Okay, that I get. I don't understand. There's something on the internet that kind of bothers me. So let me sit around with another focus group of people.
A focus group.
Who literally just want to shit on it.
Yeah, it's fun.
There is something broken in your fucking head.
And now there's something broken in your head. But you can't have both the talk where you try and be above me and better and condescendingly tell me how to live life. And at the same time saying there's something broken in my head. You can't expect both of them. So either lash out on the viewer and on the trolls. You know, either get really pissed off or be completely chill. Because this is a little bit, confusing and contradictory.
You conduct yourself in life. Really?
No, it's not in life. It's literally making fun of a lolcow on the internet. He still can't fucking realize what this is. He's acting like he's talking to the SOK. Which, if this was him talking to the SOK, if this still exists, I would understand it. But it's not. Trolls nowadays, and I'm gonna tell you because I talk to them and I engage with them on Twitter and on YouTube and stuff and I watch their stuff. Trolls nowadays are chill as fuck. And they do stuff that they think is fun. King Jad started rapping. Shinko he's doing his own thing with the pre-stream podcast recap and with he used to do the Snow Carl songs with Jay-Z. That shit was funny as fuck. And they all do what they think is funny and fun and entertaining. And they're just fucking having fun. Because the SOK, they were trying to do gay ops and be like absolutely morons. But yeah, people nowadays chill as fuck. And he's making this big fucking speech.
Really? And this is coming from
this
someone.
Big speech. You're dedicating your whole existence. No, this is your whole existence. That's the thing we're making fun of. That this is the entire DSP life is a reality show that we see every day. In the days that we don't see, he has a special segment about recapping. So thank you, Phil.
Who used to do it? I can tell you from my own personal experience, when I was younger, in my early 20s, in the Street Fighter community, I used to be a part of that.
Big ups for the massive positivity bomb by Gabe Boone? I'm sorry, I butchered it. But he says, thanks for streaming. Great work. You've put more effort in your 5-month-old channel than DSP has in his 13-year legacy. Well, big ups. Thanks. Happy you appreciate the effort. Let's keep shitting on Phil some more.
Would actually find people in the community.
Oh, this music is getting a little bit extreme.
Attitudes, their elitist ways, the fact that they had these really messed up situations where they would rig tournaments and things so that the certain people would always be ahead and win while others would never have a fair chance to actually win in Street Fighter tournaments. And this has happened a lot back in the day, I hate to say it, okay?
Oh, and this
I
is
was
a,
the guy who would
a weird
troll
segment.
The fuck out of those people on the internet. I would make fun of them, razz them, talk shit to them, just basically do everything I could possibly do to annoy the living fuck out of those people because I felt they deserved it, okay? Now, that was definitely a time in my life that I look back on now, all right? And I say, I massively regret it. I think that everything I did back then was a waste of my time. Anything that had to do with the trolling, by the way, not just playing competitive Street Fighter, But anything that had to do with the trolling, with harassing people online, with being a complete dick, right? I feel like that was a mistake. And to this day,
okay.
A lot of the things that I said and did back then.
All right, you were dumb. You regret literally everything, bro. Come on.
Cringe. I'm like, man, I'm embarrassed that that was me.
Oh, yeah, that was cringe. Now, begging for tips every day, that's so much better. He's moved on and he's grown up so much.
Grown in the last 20-some years.
He's grown. He's picking his ear on camera, burping in the microphone, belching in the microphone, snorting, sneezing, fell asleep on stream a couple of times. There's footage of him several times. Devouring food on camera. He's so mature and such an adult. And he has absolute right to tell me what I should do with my time. That he respects so much. He respects my time so much. That before he starts playing the video game, he needs to talk about himself for 2 hours. This is how much he respects my time. That he talks shit about.
I've grown as a person. I've definitely changed.
Grown as a person.
Nothing like the guy.
So do you think it's more productive if I just sit there and listen to DSP whine about his fucking life for 2 hours? Or I make a video about him shitting on him? And it being a little bit funny. Which is more productive? I would say the fucking video. Because somebody's gonna see it. And it's gonna maybe make somebody laugh.
Guy that I was back then. And now I look from the other side of all of this. I've come out
very
of
productive.
That hate, that toxicity. Crapping on things.
Yeah, come out of the negativity. Now, Neil Druckmann. Troy Baker. They're all pieces of shit. Then who else? The shills playing the games early, the trolls, who else? I don't know. Everybody is a piece of shit. But nowadays, he's shitting on people that are actually generally hated. So it's easier for him to shit on it and get away with it. That's what he does. It's much easier. When you shit on Bobby Kotick, who is considered an asshole, when you shit on him, and that's chill, you get away with it. It's okay. But you can get as toxic as you want.
Right? I'm happily married.
Game devs, awesome, of course.
Cat who's sitting in the window right here being very silly, walking back and forth. I live in a nice house. I have a great job where I get to interact with
it's a condo.
Audience every single day. I get to do what I love for a living, playing video games and having a great time with social interactions with you guys. I look at it from a different perspective today. Okay? And I look back at how I was back then. I say, maybe the reason that I was like that back then is because I didn't have anything like that. I was miserable.
Huh?
I didn't have the things that I wanted. My life wasn't a positive life. So because I was so miserable, I wanted to...
Oh, wow. That's amazing. I fucking love this, man. I fucking love this. Possibly. He's convincing himself that this is the life of everybody that hates him. This is the copium that he's on. He's on like a million liters of copium per hour. He's just sipping them and sipping some Kool-Aid with it. He's completely in it. Completely in this fantasy. That every single person that dislikes him in some way and expresses that, whether that is from a shitty song or a shitty stream, or a good stream and a good song and a good video and a Photoshop or whatever, all these people are miserable. And they are worse than Phil, and he is better because he is Phil. And we are not. And he has convinced himself so much that he's gonna grandstand. He's gonna stand on top of Mount Everest to tell you how good he is and how much he's improved. And you are fucked in the head for even daring to make something that mocks him.
Right?
How dare you?
So maybe if more people were just happy.
More people, if more people were happy. If more people were happy, the Taliban wouldn't fucking take over countries.
They wouldn't want.
If more people were happy, a lot of stuff, DSP. What the fuck is this bottom line?
To hurt others and be nasty to them? That's kind of what I'm thinking.
All right.
You got to realize something, right? These people who hate follow people, they actually have hate focus groups.
But you don't know them. You don't know these people. You don't listen to them, right? They don't matter. They just fuel you.
Focus in on just...
But they're fucked in the head. They're miserable.
It's probably because they're miserable themselves.
All right. It's probably... He said probably, dude.
Internet who are successful should be successful. So we've got to bring them...
No, not all of them. I think for you, that's what I think. I'm not shitting on the other people. I do think that there's other people that shouldn't be successful on the internet, obviously. But I'm just making fun of Phil because his life is a reality show and a lot of those other people's isn't.
Down.
A big ups Zomb for the sub. Right?
So Dark Side Phil. We just don't like him for whatever reason, because there's a million reasons why people don't like me, right? But we have a concerted effort to try to shit on this guy.
It's not a concerted effort. Why is it a concerted effort? It's like, I don't know, because I understand this as in a... I guess I conspire with other people to make this stream so we can fucking hate on DSP or something. I don't know. It's just people do stuff, and then naturally other people are engaged by it. But he doesn't understand natural engagement, because he gets none. He's never have got any.
Some fucking...
I mean, I wouldn't say never. He got a certain group of people that care about him.
Weird
reason. But...
Some weird obsessive, yeah, weird ass,
I don't know,
reason, right?
Why not?
So
the weird ass reason is that it's fun. That's at least for me. Is just fun because this guy I can make a stream about because I can watch his content.
Motherfucking piece of shit cocksucker.
Oh, that's gonna be a long one, but Big Ups Code Hustler, I'm gonna let it play.
Find out who the fuck you are. You motherfucker.
You motherfucker.
Are fucked. Let this be known live on the internet. You're fucked and you are done.
And you are done. So yeah, it's engagement. It's engagement, but big ups, Hood Hustler, for the oh no, you didn't $10 tip. Guess what, Grug? None of us are daily bankrupt beggars with 500k in debts. No friend, no roommate for a wife. No 20 years of grudges that you refuse to let go. So yeah, we are better than you will ever be. And you drink yourself to sleep knowing this. That was a big one. That was a hard one, man. That was like when Keemstar told him to get a fucking job.
Get a real fucking job.
Oh, big ups, Good Hustler. But you're a little bit mean, man. Come on. You need to be positive. You drink yourself to sleep.
I do a premiere stream of a new game.
Yeah.
Admittedly, the game is slow-paced, 3 hours, no progress, really, besides getting through the intro. So we haven't even seen the game.
Okay. Well, you should play it faster. I don't know.
Opinion on it yet, because we really haven't played the game. The stream ends.
Oh, and now he's getting a super chat that says, you laugh us off, but we give a legit criticism, and you've been negative lately. As us, how we feel and see yourself. Ask us, I guess that's supposed to be. Don't respect us, Phil. You don't respect
us,
Phil.
What is the talk? Is it a...
Doesn't respect anybody. Like, legit. Like, legit. Even the people that give him a lot of money, he looks down on.
No, it's about, oh, it's because...
The guy that gave him a lot of money. Because he doesn't like only iced coffee because he's a weirdo and he doxes people. And he's basically Fred, but on the DSP side. He doesn't like Kevin because he's a dent. Doesn't like his mods because they're weirdos and some of them are, I don't know, strange and do bizarre stuff. He doesn't like Derek, because Derek tags him in tweets of, like, porn stars and shit. He doesn't like anybody. He doesn't respect all of them. Because he's the guy making the content, which, by default, he thinks makes him absolutely superior than all of the people that are paying his bills. That's why.
A lot of tips, right? Right? It's just ridiculous. I don't understand... I really don't understand how you can live like that, because I lived like that for a bit, and after a while, I had to change myself. Like, I was so...
Yeah, he's the Grug Fox.
Like, I told you guys, I fell into
depression. Oh, not Fred Fox, that
I
guy dead.
Everything that was going on around me and my life and everything. And it wasn't until, really, that I realized that things that I did on this planet could actually have a positive impact on others, that things kind of turned around for me. It really was when I started content on YouTube.
Bro.
And people were saying, wow, Phil.
Bro.
You know...
Bro, this is like, this is terrible logic, because there's always those people that are going to exist, because it's the internet. Come on. And he's been doing this for 14 years. All those people will always exist. Just how, and I'm not trying to equate this with DSP, but how some serial killers got fangirls that chase them around, which is irrational. Why would you be a fan of somebody who committed such crimes? But they just fucking exist, because it's just a group of people that exist. So if he's just doing something based on a couple of people, or let's say 10, 20, 30 comments that he read, that he made a lot of meaningful content, and takes this as a sign to just keep doing this until he dies, that's a terrible decision. It's just bad.
Bad day, and because I watched your videos, you put a smile on my face, you turned it around for me. Thank you.
Okay? Thank you.
That kind of thing started making me feel good about myself for the first time in many, many years. And when I started seeing that, then it just went hand in hand with more positivity. Because positivity...
More positive.
Just like negativity breeds more negativity. If you want to feel good, then you have to surround yourself with positive things. You can't shit on things constantly because that's not positive. And all that's going to happen, you're going to get this ball of negativity.
But it depends. It depends, actually. It depends. Because I watch YouTube and I can tell you there's a lot of people that shit on things positively. And a lot of lists that I've seen of top 10 worst movies, top 10 worst games, some movie that is bad that they make a review of that is shitting on it, but it's in a positive way. It has like a funny spin to it. It's lighthearted. They're joking with the movie, and yeah, it's bad, but it doesn't have to be toxic. That's the thing. And of course, I'm fucking toxic. I call him all kinds of shit because fuck him. I don't care about being fucking positive for him. But obviously, I don't like him. Big ups to your boy for a super chat. If you were Phil, would you respect anybody who supported you? Knowing how you appear and how you speak, who in their right mind would support you? Well, if I was Phil, I would figure I would have a very high opinion of myself. So those people that support me, I think they would be good people just because they like me and they support me. Because they can't be bad people. But then when I'm faced with the facts, with what some of them have done, like with OIC for being just generally a fucking idiot, then I would probably not respect them a lot. And big ups for Karma Kid for the super chat. Gears in the head spinning so fast. Rest in peace, that hairline. This whole 40 minutes is just like a massive spiral, man, into completely, I don't know, insanity.
Around you, and that's your life now. Your life is crapping on things because
you're... But that's not. No, that's not my life. That's not my life, though. It's not. What you are right about is that that is your life, because he is so absorbed by this streaming and being a dark side Phil. That's the whole thing. Because he doesn't realize that we don't do this as a job. We do this for fun, and we stream when we can, when we are in the mood, and when we feel like it. That's it. And we post on Twitter when we feel like it. We don't have any schedule. We don't have any responsibilities outside of the kind of the common sense responsibility of when you're going to make a video or a stream, you know, you try and put some effort in it. That's the only thing. And you can also not put any effort at all, because we don't have the responsibility for anything. You know what I mean?
You see what I'm saying? And that's a terrible way to go through life. And I know that firsthand now from being through it myself. The problem is, when you're in that situation, it's very hard to listen to people on the outside. Because if you're unhappy with your own life, right? You don't want to hear from people who have it better than you. You don't want to hear from the person on the other side saying, oh, well, I'm happy now, you can be happy too. Fuck you, you're happy, fuck you. That was kind of my attitude back then. So that's how I can...
That's his attitude now. That's his attitude literally now.
From, I just wish that I could get through to them and be like, listen, I really wish that people could...
This guy's wild.
That
what?
If you would stop with that, if you just took a step back and said, I'm going to give it a rest for a while, instead of being a complete nasty, negative person...
Then you would vanish. Then there would be nobody to give attention to your pay pigs, and nobody to inflate your views. If all of that stopped for like a week, he would witness a massive amount of decline in his business. And I know he's going to go the wings route and say, leave me alone no matter what. Let me just burn out my own way. And I would understand this, but this is not going to happen, DSP. You've become the content catalyst you are. And this rant by itself is a big victory for the trolls, because they made so much content out of it. Just like I'm doing now. And just like I've seen many streams of people talking about this. And I was watching them. And I was listening to this rant. So he gave us so much to talk about with this bullshit.
I'm going to give it a rest. I'm going to walk away from it, right? And you go focus on things that are better.
Yeah, he was challenging restreamers to take a break, to take a month, and was like, okay, just let me, if I become irrelevant, just let me become irrelevant. Let's see.
You can actually turn your life around. I did, you know?
No, you didn't. You literally didn't. How are you trying to convince yourself? And I know. Now, he's in this situation where I can relate to, because I run this stream. When you're streaming and you're sitting in this room and you're talking to yourself, essentially. or you're talking on a Zoom call, that is easier to believe nowadays, or Discord or whatever. But there's nobody talking out the other end because you're the guy making the stream, you know, you're the guy. And when you're kind of a guy like DSP and you read all these super chats and all this stuff calling you nice things and you effectively read them to yourself, there's this copium that happens that he does, which is reading his like the super chats, the saying, Phil, you're so great, you're so amazing, thank you, this is amazing. And I can understand how this happens, but you shouldn't be letting it go too much to your head, because then you're gonna feel like DSP and be able to convince yourself things are not reality. He turned around his life into what? He had a hot underage, borderline underage girlfriend back in the day. He had a revenue stream that was seemingly endless. It was just a big bag of cash every day. And he was just moving into a new home. He was making everywhere he went. He would take the camcorder and terribly film everything so he could write it off on his taxes and he could make extra money. And he turned it around into being a beggar, you're trying to tell me? A guy that flexes about the volatility of streaming being a nice thing that he likes. That someday you can make $10 and other day you can make $150. Wow.
Yeah. And I wish that my
message sure turned it around.
People, but I know that sometimes it will never will, because there's people who are so ingrained in this groupthink mentality of hate. Like I said, it really is
hate. The king of hate. The hate army. He did the Hate Live podcast for 5 years? 2013, 2018. 5 years.
Came together to just talk about hate live. Hate something. Right?
But it's funny.
Which is no way to go through life. So it's just crazy.
And it's also about curiosity, being just curious to how this guy works and how he exists and how he functions and how he manages to take all the bait and have a meltdown and just be cringy.
Crazy. Admittedly yesterday, me being completely upfront and honest with everyone right now on the internet, you ready? Yeah, I wish that it went better when it came to
that. I know.
Of course I do.
You literally wish every day. That's a normal thing to wish for.
Premiere stream. You would think that if people enjoyed the premiere stream, they're gonna.
But you do more than wishing about it. You try and speak it into existence. You know what I mean? You ask for it. You guys, tip's been slow. It's been 47 minutes since the last tip. It's been 20 minutes. It's been 15 minutes. Come on, tip me. Last chance to tip. This is what those streams turn into, an auction house.
We're gonna support the premiere stream.
$25, number one, number two. Number three,
that means it goes hand in
goes to 1 minute, man, for $25.
Yeah, right? And that means it's a good day for me. I don't have to worry about
I totally fucked this one up.
I can just play games and have a good time or whatever, right? Right. But that was not the end-all be-all of the stream.
It's not the end-all be-all, but that would be garbage if it was. It kind of is, but
it was more of an exploratory.
It is garbage.
The intro. Today we're going to get further into the game, into the meat of the game, and maybe understand it a little more and like it a little more. Or on the flip side, dislike it a little more, right? Dependent on how it goes. So let's see today how it goes, right? But what's just crazy about that is these people don't understand that. They actually think, wow, Phil had one bad stream. Ha ha ha. Let's revel in this.
It's funny. It's funny because it gets to you. It obviously does. Look at this. This clip is 43 minutes long. 43 minutes. And I've been probably talking about it for an hour. This one clip. Dude, obviously you take all the bait, and you beg, and when you beg and you don't get the money, you give salt. And it's funny. It's as simple as it can describe it.
Let's go and post about it on forums.
So he was reading Kiwi Farms.
Threads.
So it's Kiwi Farms.
Post up on our social media about
social media, so Twitter.
Phil had a bad stream.
Wow, had a bad stream.
Silent majority really helped Phil.
Silent
today.
Majority. Oh, copium. And now we're going to segue into fuck you. You got fucked.
He didn't get his tips call today. Haha. It's like, dude.
Like
how
what?
How on earth do you go through life like this?
I don't know what people are saying in his chat, but
you know,
it's his chat.
You can't. At some point, you have to realize what you're doing is a complete waste of your time and you could have a better life.
Why? Why? Why do you think it's a complete waste of time? Should I be playing video games? Is that super productive? Should I be watching Netflix, for example? Should I be watching Derek's Twitter, for example? Should I do that? Who determines what is a good amount of time to be spent on something? What is a good amount of time spent on something? Who determines if it's productive or not, aside from me and you?
You know?
For your own time. You know what I mean?
It's hard. It really is, again, from being...
So if I wanted to make some ASMR videos, just sitting here doing this all day, I guess, I mean, I would see that as a waste of time, but maybe somebody's going to write me a comment and tell me, wow, this changed my life. I wanted to log into Minecraft, but after I watched this video, I logged out, I deleted Minecraft, and now I want to continue living my life. Does this make it meaningful? What is this fucking arbitrary gatekeeping bullshit? You trying to gatekeep literal shitpost videos of people that don't like you? Well, you're not gonna succeed. Come on, it's the fucking internet. You gotta take it. Sometimes people are gonna say stuff about you that you're not gonna like, and it's gonna sound lame. And maybe they're gonna be right, maybe they're gonna be not right. But you gotta take it. You kinda have to, because it's the internet. If it's in real life, you don't have to take it. You can turn around and waddle away like a little penguin.
In that situation myself when I was younger, I understand
why. He's giving us a flashback to a million years ago where people didn't like him, and now they don't like him at all. So nothing changed.
How you could get caught up in that. And today with the internet, being an anonymous person on the internet, you could get so caught up with it because you're just, there's no,
you could have been anonymous person.
And no one will ever call you out for it, nor will everyone ever even find out that you did. We're a part.
All right, Boomer, I get it.
Everything's anonymous.
You don't like the internet. You need to give Mark Zuckerberg your ID so you can have Facebook. That's what he wants, to give Zuck the ID.
So
the guy who values nobody's privacy, give him all your information, dude. What could happen? Bank leaks? No.
It's even
worse. No, that doesn't happen, dude.
Was, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so anyway.
It's worse than it's ever been. Yeah, because you're a piece of shit today more than you've ever been.
Summary, I liked the Dying Light 2 stream. I want to say thumbs up.
Oh, you liked it. Of course you're going to say you liked it because you're trying to own the trolls. Because if you say you didn't like it, you were going to be right. Which we are anyways, because he didn't like it.
Everyone who attended it, everyone who liked the stream. There was.
He doesn't like a single stream that doesn't make $150. Because the goal of the stream, the whole idea it exists, is to make him the money. At this point, he doesn't give a fuck about the games. Video games. He's not about that. If he did, he wouldn't be talking about it for an hour and a half. Talking about how he's gonna play games instead of just playing games.
Great engagement. There was actually overall...
But the engagement was great, man.
All the levels of support that came in during the stream, it was actually a really good stream.
Yeah, of course it is.
I can't.
Every stream is great.
I mean, yes, again, admittedly.
Except by his own words, when a stream is good, he gets his money. When it's not good, he doesn't. So apparently it wasn't good, but it was.
Would I have liked tips to be higher because it would have directly helped me this week with paying bills and the like? Yes.
Yeah, why do you even need to say this?
But I'm also not going
to
sit here.
Yeah, would I like to make more money in life? Yes.
Wow. Disaster.
Welcome to common sense.
Disaster stream. End of the world.
Now, no, nobody said this.
Everything's terrible, and now I'm going to be all...
Every stream is a disaster for DSP, man. Come on, what the fuck?
All pissy about it.
But yeah, they got to him, just like when Keemstar got to him. But Keemstar truly, truly, legitimately got to him.
Get a real fucking job. You're still on mission one. You're begging for $10 and $20 to pay your rent.
Absolutely savage. And Keemstar is an asshole. I would just like to point this out. He's a massive fucking cringe lord.
Of course not. Of course I'm not going to fucking do that. That would be so ungrateful. That would be so disrespectful to those who were there.
Thanks for crossing your arms, by the way. It makes me really trust you more.
Good stream? You know what I'm saying?
No, not really.
It's absolutely ridiculous that these people turn everything into a negative. It is.
Bro, it's literally, they don't like you. What do you expect them to do? They will never like you because you're not likable. And we've already made our minds that we don't like you and you don't like us. And that's the situation and it's whatever. I don't have any stakes in his life. I don't care. He can fucking stop streaming tomorrow. I'm not gonna care. I'm just gonna go away if I have nothing to talk about. It's just a fucking thing like that. I don't have stakes in the Burnell household. I haven't invested anything in it. So I don't care. But he treats us like we're involved in his life in any way. Which we're Not really, except the people that do gay ops and try and mess with his life. Now, which I don't participate in.
Funny thing about that.
What is the funny thing?
I didn't just do one stream yesterday, right? I did two. The second stream was Street Fighter.
And now we segue into the flexing. Now it's the victory lap around the trolls because he got money one day.
Okay. So as I played Street Fighter, guess what happened? People came.
People. The regular pay pigs. Why? Because you whined.
A couple various reasons. Number one, because they like Street Fighter. They like seeing me play old school Street Fighter because they realize that's me in my element.
It's terrible. It's terrible. Genuinely terrible watching him play video games, particularly Street Fighter. Because if you've watched one session, you've watched literally all of them. You've watched one highlights video by anybody. You've seen all of them. It's just the same thing. And it's so stale. It's so stale.
Those are games
it's like moldy bread.
Those are games that I know a ton about knowledge-wise. Probably
he knows a ton about.
Knowledge-wise, besides maybe classic RPGs like Final Fantasy. It's really the only games where I can say, hey, here's how the game works. Here's the mechanics. I can explain at a technical level to people, right? And there's just people who absolutely enjoy watching me in my element like that because it's a rarity that I get to do that, right? But number two, I would guarantee you, I guarantee that what ended up happening was that people looked at how people reacted to the first stream of the day.
Big ups, Alfred Aponte for $2 super chat. Big ups to all. Grug is desperate. He is desperate. Is he today, though? What is he talking about right now?
Wow. People were real
big ups for a super chat.
He put out a good stream.
Overall, who said this? Who fucking said this? Bro. And this is another method of coping, like I said earlier, when you talk to yourself way too much, you believe yourself way too much. So now we have this putting words in other people's mouth. Anonymous online people that just came and gave him a tip because he didn't make the tips earlier. They came and gave it to him and he wants to frame it as something else. He wants to frame it as, man, people were shit-talking Phil. We gotta support him. We're a part of a family. We're all together. It's a team. It's the kingdom of hate. We're the soldiers of hate.
Stream. It wasn't a disaster stream. Yeah, tips were lower than would have been expected for a premiere. But overall, that was pretty good. And look at people being so fucking nasty to Phil, right?
Bro, they've been since like 2012. What?
What did they do?
They've done so much more. Yeah, they... The goals. All right.
I exceeded the goals.
All right. Good.
Was I expecting that? Fuck no.
All right. Why do you expect me to care? Because now, more than ever, I have less reason to care about how much money he makes. Like I said earlier, I used to log into like Dark Dave and clock in at least once a day to just see how much money he's making, to see if there's going to be any salt or not. And when the leaks happen, I just stopped giving a fuck because I know where it all goes. It goes towards nothing. Like I said earlier, again, 1 minute, man. Has just a daily subscription to DSP for $25. That's all he has. There's no end goal. There's nothing that they're building. There's nothing that's going to be achieved. It's just give me $25 daily. That's all that it is. So then you stop caring about how much he makes and you just wait for the salt that's going to happen when he doesn't make a lot. And then the next crisis and the next crisis, that's just how it is.
Stream, it's not that case. In fact, usually we actually struggle.
So now when he flexes on me, I don't care because that money is gone. That money that he got, that he's flexing about, is gone. It doesn't exist.
Even hit the tier 2 tip skull because I like to put on this hat, which I call it the M. Bison hat. It looks like M. Bison's hat. And I put it on.
Kind of looks like a Nazi hat.
Yes. All right.
M. Bison hat.
We don't always hit it. In fact, the last few weeks we didn't hit it.
He's the most disappointing person.
People came out last night and said, hey, we decided that we want to support Phil tonight. Was it directly because of the shit that was said about me on the internet with the Dying Light stream or not?
Bro, no.
But
no, it wasn't. So you see spoilers. What I'm saying? Like, it wasn't. Because they say this shit every day. I know. I like their tweets. They say this shit every day. On Kiwi Farms on Twitter, they're going to complain about anything he does. So will I. Because that's the funny part of it. That's what makes it fun. Complaining about it and whining. And he never changes. That's what keeps it fun. So we get to talk about this TV show, this reality show, in reality show. And that's what keeps it funny. Congratulations, you figured it out.
all the idiocy of these people in the morning for the dying live stream meant absolutely nothing anyway, because then I went on to have a successful night stream that was really good. So, social. Fuck you. No, really. The life of fuck the party. You.
What is he talking about? Let's
no matter what.
Oh, fuck you. Okay. Let's check up on him for a second. Let's see what the fuck's happening.
He either wants to bother you or...
Oh, no. Fuck this. We do not care.
Focus so much on negativity and all you want to do is shit on me. You got fucked last night, didn't you?
No. Literally. Did not care. Will not care. Never. He can get $1,000. I will not care. Because I've come to terms that what I just told you about is the money is vanished. It's going to evaporate. And he's going to beg tomorrow. So it doesn't matter. It's only fun when he doesn't make the money. And that's it. When he makes the money, it's just simply not fun. That's it. I don't get pissed off. I don't get mad. There's nothing to get mad about. It's just some internet asshole. I don't have stakes in his life. As he would like to believe himself and convince himself that we are really invested in his life to like a personal degree. We dedicate our whole lives to study about him and watch him and hate him. That's not true. And that reality might make him feel less important because we're not super obsessed with him. But it's just kind of funny, man. It's really not that special.
Because you're morons. Because
we are morons. Not the guy that thinks that we are personally involved in his life. Like, what am I going to say? I can just get angry. If he gets like $100, $200, like whatever. I don't think he deserves it. That's by default because you know I'm here for this. To say I don't think he deserves it.
Actually create the situation.
And that's it.
Right? That then allows me to go on and continue to be successful.
But you're not successful. That is the best thing about this. That when he doesn't get the money, it's fun. It's entertaining. It's funny. We see the gold dust. We see the reality show. When he gets the money, it's boring. And it's whatever. It's whatever. You skip it. You ignore it. But he never becomes successful. That is the best thing. He's never successful. He's never gonna be successful. And the success that he had was one of the worst kinds of success when you're half notorious and half cheese the system. So you're actually nothing in the end. Your success is really kind of short-timed. And now he exists basically on the mercy of a couple of people and the trolls who keep making stuff about him, which are guilty, I guess.
You understand, but yeah, that, right?
Like, it's like, no, you're not successful, but you're successful at being a lol cow. And that is what we enjoy seeing, I guess, the successful lol cow.
I've only said this a million times and I'll say it again. When people say I can't do something, that motivates me to then come back from that and do better.
You've never done that.
You're not a good content creator.
You're not. Simply, objectively not a good content creator. He is not.
Not a good streamer.
Not a good streamer. Nothing about his stream makes me think that he's a good streamer. There is not one thing about his stream that makes me think that he's a good streamer. Not one. Not the layout, not the sounds, not the visual aesthetic, not the quality, actual quality of the streams, not the upload and the care that he puts into uploading the videos and making his channel look nice. Not his attitude, not his behavior. Not him burping in the microphone, belching, snorting, sneezing, and falling asleep makes me believe that he is a good content creator. None of these.
You can't put out entertaining content.
That is factually correct.
You'll never hit your goals.
And your goals are just dependent on people giving you money. So that's not really motivating you. It's motivating other people to give you money so you can hit your goals.
Never be successful.
You're not successful. You somewhat used to be. You're not.
I say, fuck you.
Well, okay. All right, big ups Glamorous Dynamo for the sub.
I will do it.
I feel owned by a person that I'm absolutely in no way involved in, and he influences me in no way other than providing me with entertainment that I sort of make myself and sort of he makes. So yeah, I don't really know. I guess, I need to do something else, man.
You've motivated me to do better. And that's exactly what happened yesterday. Thank you, DSP. Right?
You're welcome.
A situation where, okay, the first stream was unexpectedly slow.
unexpectedly slow. Big deal.
It's not the end of the world for me. All right. Still playing Dying Light. Nothing's changed.
What if the second stream was unexpectedly slow? What if that was $30? The whole narrative would be completely different. The fucking trolls made fun of me. I had one slow day. One slow day, and they're acting like the business is dying. I'm still successful.
And then the night stream ends up blowing all the goals, right?
Blowing all the goals.
Going crazy. Wow. Now, here's the thing, and I want to say this. I want to make this abundantly clear to my viewing audience, especially those of you who are big supporters of mine, okay? Please.
Tip me.
Listen up. This is very important, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, I appreciate all the support that I get for all the content that I put out, no matter what kind of support it is. It could be just simply liking the stream, liking the video, leaving a comment, a membership, a super chat, a super sticker, a tip, a pledge to my Patreon.
But DSP, I'm going to cut you off. I'm going to let you finish. But Beyonce? Never mind. DSP, you don't appreciate. That is the problem. Because appreciation, when you appreciate something, you commit to doing some action that expresses that appreciation. So, for example, if you appreciate people watching your stream, you will respect them enough not to burp into the microphone, not to actually, to behave yourself professionally and to run your stream properly and to know how to use OBS. That is appreciating people. That's why you strive to make better stuff and you learn more stuff. You don't appreciate people. That is the biggest problem with you. You don't appreciate anything. And somehow you keep asking for it, and somehow further you keep getting it. And that's why we're watching. This is what we watch. The reality show. And the premise of the reality show is simple. A washed up, terrible gamer from back in the day is having a super bizarre lifestyle of just asking for stuff, getting it, and keep asking for stuff, keep getting it. That's the whole premise. It's a pretty engaging reality show. And he made it. He crowdfunded the first, 14 seasons? And now we're bankrolling it. But it's okay. We're going to get through. It's not going to get canceled anytime soon. The actor is too... can't find another job. He's too much of this character.
Merch is available. Buying merch. Sharing my videos.
Buying fucking merch. Imagine buying merch. And imagine showing your friends videos of Darkside Phil.
Telling other people about myself.
No. That is impossible. They're going to hate me.
Liking my tweets, retweeting my...
That is terrible. Your tweets are bad and are just served to promote yourself or shit on somebody else.
Tweets. There's a bajillion ways you can support my content. Okay? A bajillion ways.
Oh, yeah. And Patreon. Of course. Just give me money to exist.
Please do me this one favor and make me a promise. Okay? If you're going to support my content, please support it because you like me and my content. And you would think that that would be like common sense, right? I'm only supporting Phil because I like him and his content, all right? However, sadly, in the modern day...
In the modern day.
There are people who have the wrong idea, and sadly, there are people who actually exploit their viewers and followers. And I don't ever want to do that,
You literally do it. You literally do it. That nonsense with playing games with people, with the buy-in... That is 100% exploitation. 100% you're exploiting them. Because you're dangling a carrot and claiming that you're going to play with them or this is going to happen or Project 7 is going to come back. And then you hit the goal. And when you hit the goal, the money is gone. It's in your bank account. It's spent on whatever. It's gone. So you start thinking about the future, right? How are you going to take more money next and not fulfill what you dangled the carrot for? No. That's not how it is. That's exploiting your viewers. Because, personally, I haven't seen a streamer that relies on their viewers as much as DSP. For anything. To teach him how to use OBS. To help him out with all these free assets for his stream. For intros, outros, all this shit. For literally supporting his entire life. I haven't seen a different guy.
Like, that's the situation.
It's kind of sad.
Okay, here's what I mean by that. Yesterday...
Oh, is he going to get a fake injury? I don't know. But there's going to be health issues down the line, 1,000%. There's going to be big goals to hit. And big up Smeech for managing to watch this live.
Dying Light 2 stream, didn't do great with tips.
And big ups to Matt, who's going to listen to this later.
So now what I like people to say
Ups, you're going
to
hear this segment where I give you a shout out.
Didn't do so well. I'm going to support him on the night stream. And then you go do it because you like the content. What I don't want to happen.
This is terrible, by the way. This is a terrible... It's a terrible way to tell people, look, if you want to give me money, do it in this way, not in this way. No, bro, you're there to get money, right? This is your job. So fuck it. If people want to own the trolls, let them own the trolls. That's good for you. Fuck them. Because you want to push this imaginary war between you and your trolls, between your hate army and the trolls. That war, I don't fucking know if it exists. It's a fucking... I don't know. Who's doing wars against a fucking lol cow? What the fuck? But he wants to push this war like it's a big thing, just so he can get more people on his side. And further make them drink the Kool-Aid. Drink that Kool-Aid, man. If you love me, if you like me, drink this Kool-Aid, please.
All right? Ever. Is that maybe you didn't even attend the Dying Light 2 stream. You weren't even aware that it wasn't so good. Okay?
Typically, what if I didn't care?
Everything else was good. But then you start...
He never, by the way, he's never... mentioned the possibility of people not caring. I brought this up earlier. I'm going to bring it back again. Because that's, I think, 80% on YouTube is making people care. Which is, you can put out a video that you've worked for endlessly, but people simply would not care about. And it's going to demotivate you. It's going to make you feel bad, I guess, because you enjoyed it. But yeah, that's kind of how it is, man. But he never assumes that people just simply wouldn't care about him playing this game.
Following the wrong people.
Oh yeah, if there was a war, it would have been won. But the whole thing is just he has shit to lose. We're talking about he is acting like there's a war happening in his life. But it's not in my life. I don't fucking have a war against him. Because that would imply that I'm personally engaged with this on a personal level. They have a war with the DSP. How fucking retarded is that?
You're in the wrong circles, those hate circles.
Okay? The hate circles. You're in the wrong circles.
Fill out a disaster stream, die.
Like, what? Where do you come from? Where you expect me to believe this advice? Just because you're old? Just because you've lived longer? What? Why? No, you failed. You've been failing this entire time. You failed. This entire time, and you expect me to take your advice?
Dying Light 2 stream does terrible for tips. What are you? His business is going out of business. Oh, the silent.
Yeah, we've been saying this for like 5 years now. Come on.
Doherty didn't support him this time, and ha ha ha.
Yeah, it's just funny.
You watch their negative shit.
Okay.
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 And you say, all right, what I would like to do then is I want to stick it to them, I want to stick it to the haters.
And this is a little bit of reverse psychology, because that same stream, people came out and supported in droves for some reason. I don't know why.
So I'm going to go to Phil's late stream, and I'm going to support him on his late stream just to stick it to the haters, okay? Please don't do that. Really. Please
really. This some nice moral grandstanding, assuming that he's better just because.
I don't want anyone
supporting
just to stick it to a group of toxic people. All right, those people eventually need to look in the mirror themselves and say, what am I doing with my life? But when you have that kind of an obstacle.
But bro, this is not my life. This is my hobby, you could say, because it is fun to do. And I can't speak for everybody. Obviously, I can only speak for myself. And this is a fun thing. It's an entertaining thing. It's not my life, but it's your life. That's what we're talking about.
The attitude against those people, they will never improve. In fact, all that will happen, it'll be like two groups with rock-headed heads butting like this, okay?
What?
Seriously.
Seriously. Wise,
if you're coming to my streams and my content, and you're here to enjoy...
Yeah, DSP, we learn from the SOK. We learn from them. So we know that you shouldn't get too personally invested, and you should know that it's just a fucking show, and just watch the show, laugh at it. And make your own stuff about it. Interpret it in the way that you want. And fucking, I don't know, if you think you should mock him, you mock him. Fuck him.
For positive reasons, great. Please support for positive reasons. Do not come here and say, I'm just going to come and support just to stick it to a toxic group of people on the internet. I don't want that, all right? You want to know why I call that? The Druckmann method.
Oh, that's no.
The Druckmann method.
No, I'm going to skip through this. Now, this is absolutely an abomination of a segment. He talks about Druckmann method, how he said that everybody who doesn't buy dying, The Last of Us 2 was a bigot and a racist and a homophobe or whatever. It's just lunacy. It's just lunacy. So let's skip to the end of this segment because this guy is tiring.
Etc. All right. That's what I'm going for. And I hope you guys understand that. And I hope that's what you attend the streams for. And that's why you support them. I hope. Okay?
Hey, big ups Dark C DeFil for $5 super chat. Here's some dollar sign because I like your content and not to stick it to Phil. Yeah, fuck sticking it to Phil. Just like content.
I can't
make or give me money for any reason. You can play money for any reason. Oh, he played the troll intro again? The outro?
Thank you.
Wow.
Support for the right reasons.
And he's going to play Sifu now, huh? Should we check it out for a little bit? Let me see, maybe.
Long time.
Maybe.
All right, one second here.
$14. This is going to be a begathon today. It's going to turn on its fan, so meandering again.
I can't. I would just hope that we have this positive mentality.
You don't.
Do stuff with my content.
Positive fucking mentality. What is positive? What is positive mentality about him?
People aren't getting the wrong impression. I don't want to be Neil Druckmann.
Oh, I agree.
I don't want to tell you guys support me to stick it to the haters. Fuck the haters. Act like they don't exist and come and just enjoy the content for what it is.
But stop talking about them. Act like they don't exist. After 37 minutes of talking about them, 37 minutes, he couldn't get this dick out of his mouth. The hater's dick.
You're gonna stay on my dick until you die.
I need to put disgusting food in the mouths of my family members.
After 40 minutes of this, ignore them. You should just ignore them. They don't exist. How does this work, man?
Don't support
being a hypocrite. Just don't talk about them. Because this whole discussion is that some people on Twitter that are probably blocked by him at this point and on Kiwi Farms that he's not supposed to go anyways. I don't know why he was on Kiwi Farms. We're making fun of him. Because they're going to make fun of him anyways, no matter how much money he gets. They made fun of him, and this segment exists because of that.
Then, you're fighting negativity and with then, more of course, Horizon will only be PlayStation.
Oh my god,
no
he's
rings up in the air.
He's still talking about
playing on PS5 or Xbox 3.
He's still talking about games. Not even the game is booted yet. What a fucking asshole, man. This guy is just fucking terrible.
No, 672, I've never been to Mount St. Helens, but my aunt used to live here. In Washington State when it erupted. Many
That's phenomenal. Why are you stalling?
From Mount St. Helens that she
I hate this. I hate this live shit. This is garbage.
Phil streams 300 times a year, right? As long as it's not an ongoing thing.
Well, you said it was a week. It was like four streams of it.
Not a big fucking deal.
God damn it.
That's not what they won't talk about that. They won't ever talk about it or spin it like that because they don't want to accept reality. To them, any little thing that
bro.
Was a bump in the road is a win.
Bro. I don't care about your life. I'm not invested in your life. It doesn't matter to me if you make $1,000 or $1. Except if you make $1, I'm going to laugh at you. And if you make $100, I'm not going to say anything. Just going to be whatever.
To those people who are...
Because it's just like, I'm not that engaged. Why are you acting like we're on equal terms? Like, we live together or something. Or I have a store next to you. Like in Curb Your Enthusiasm, the Spite store. Like, I'm running a store opposite to his, and I'm hating on him. No, I'm not even there.
So, that hate focus group?
Hate focus group.
Focused on hate.
He's still not playing the game, by the way. Still not playing the game.
All difficult. It is action-packed. It has tons of...
Okay, let's watch some seafood.
Awesome animations.
It's delicious.
Hard as shit. Because apparently you need to...
This sack of shit lifetime. Is quiet again. He's way too quiet. Always.
That's about all I know. Everyone is saying it's incredibly difficult but rewarding once you learn the mechanics. And that's what I'm going with. So let's do it. Let's boot
her. Yeah, the Spite store. That's what he acts like we are.
Some kung fu ass.
Like, I'm gonna cry if he makes a lot of money. Bro, this shit doesn't concern me. Let's watch some gameplay. He should be bad. Let's keep watching this video yet, because, like, what the fuck is he having a seizure?
How we feel?
Oh, yeah, he read the super chat from earlier that was shitting on him, but he's going to pretend like he doesn't understand anything, because he's an asshole.
You've been negative lately. Now, that I disagree with. I actually feel like I've been way more positive.
And, well, he made 24 during the pre-stream, plus some stalling. Now he's setting up his brightness because
the icon in the bottom left hand corner of the screen shows the left thumbstick, but you actually have to use the D-pad.
Bro. Kind of bro.
Okay, so
he's fucking pig-splaining the brightness settings.
He's caught. He's choking.
Holy fuck. How hard is he trying to not play the game? We're going to watch a little bit of this, and then I'm probably going to head out or watch some more Hate Army Watch, because this video is done. This shit about the trolls.
This is the pitfall of having a pet in the room.
And, oh yeah, the trolls are getting more engagement. I'm going to see a little bit of this. There's a nice little segment here. Snow Carl came back.
Seems
and
bad.
Yeah, the trolls get higher engagement. I love this question.
Nope.
How Phil?
He's got that gag reflex going, but now he's stopping.
What the fuck is he doing?
You're freaking me out.
Oh, Jasper is dying.
Hard game and you start vomiting in my office.
Oh, Jasper, you're ruining the stream, dude. Stop ruining the fucking stream.
Yes. He understands it. I say things to him, he knows exactly what I'm saying half the time. At least half the time. He's smart.
Let me just go on his raw shit. My god, this guy is wild, man. He's sitting on the brightness screen.
Sometimes.
Okay, now we're on the subtitle screen.
Yes, okay, that's all good.
He got over 100 likes, which is kind of impressive. And 500 people watching.
Mastermind just did a $4.20 tip and says it's time for
I just switch the layout.
Have fun. You know I'm going to say that about 4,000 times during this playthrough, right? You guys have been around the block. You know what I do.
What?
You know how I roll.
You're bad at games? Like a baby.
There you go. Did I fart, and is that why Jasper is gagging? You know, possibly. You guys may not realize this, but I'm constantly ripping big ones in here. Thank you, Indead, for the super.
Yeah, game, by the way. I'm 100% sure that's happening.
By the way, thank you guys. We are just starting with gameplay. We already have over 100 likes on the stream.
Likes. Really, really talking about likes again.
Visibility. I really appreciate you
guys. That fucking sucks, man. Let's see where he is in the Sifu directory. Right, but I need to open like a private mode for this.
And we're just going to go with new game. Wow, it's pouring rain. Right?
So, okay, I'm going to tell you. You'll have to believe me. Because I might not be able to show it on the screen.
Ooh, haptic feedback.
Okay, we go to YouTube.com. Oh, this has haptic feedback. He's going to complain about it a lot because he's a grandpa.
With the rain.
Now we go on explore. Then we go on gaming. Then, top games. I guess we need to find Sifu, huh?
Playing this guy.
I found it. 4,000 people watching.
Probably wants to get inside.
All right, live. I'm going to set to worldwide. Wow, number one has 4.2K.
Some bikes. That's
then, oh, DSP is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's number 6 that shows up.
Oh, you leave it out in the rain. That thing's going
to. He is top 6 when it comes to sorted by viewers.
Anso Kamaru just hit me $1.50 and says,
so yeah, he's hot as fuck.
Fights, I'll give you plenty of tips when
let's see if this is top 6 behavior
possible when it comes to how to do the combat, because you know me.
Oh, and he needs tips. Okay, of course he does.
So here we go.
Wait, of course
the door's locked. Heavy attack. They actually want me to kick the door in. Well, fuck this shit.
All right, I'm sorry guys that we have to watch this live, but it's kind of an event watching him play something like this.
Okay, that worked.
I can always do everything else later. Oh, can we watch the number one guy? Yeah, totally. I can do that.
L1. Okay.
To see how he's different, and you watch this guy now. That's the number level one guy.
Wow. A nice flurry. So L1 is your go-to parry button.
Okay, go back to explore. Now we go to gaming. This is how you find DSP gaming, by the way. We go to gaming. Then you go top live games, and you find the seafood section. The delicious squid. Oh, and then you see Frogga. Frogga is number 3 for me. And now DSP is number 2. I'm very confused. And then Dark Dave. But that's because I'm logged on my account, obviously. Yeah, worldwide is this guy. He's the number 1 ranked human being.
I can't see. I deflected there.
I'm going to show it to you later. Now the guy is fighting.
No! I did that way too late.
This time he came higher up in the algorithm because I wasn't in a private one. The private tab.
Pretty brutal. Double parry. But why did he attack the other way? I double parried, but then he decided to attack the air instead of the guy standing in front of him. I don't know.
All right, he killed him.
I wonder how you target, because they haven't explained it yet.
And this is the main guy.
So look at
his chat is flying.
These are like kids, right? Like that one guy had a...
Yeah, it's some guy, maybe Indonesian?
I beat up a bunch of like 13
I'm not sure.
Kind of fucked up. Who wants to go first? Getting your ass beat by a trained adult. Look, this one has a fucking pacifier there on the bench. Damn.
What?
And here's the corner where they change their diapers.
What?
Look at this guy.
Yeah, your fans change their diapers.
Ooh. Oi. By the way, whenever you go to a dojo, remember to have your complimentary plate of stacked large naval oranges.
Bro, play the fucking game. Actually, those are play the game. What are those? Go fight. What is he doing?
I forgot the name of them now. Those fruits right there.
Do you think you're funny?
I can't remember the name of it.
What?
I learned it when I played Pikmin 3 many years ago. He just opened the door with his ass. Did you see that?
Bro.
He actually turned to the door and went poop with his butt.
Play the game.
That was pretty impressive. I wish I could do that.
This guy sucks. I'd open all doors
with my butt cheeks if I could do
it. He's so bad. Right.
Let's head on up here.
There's something interesting on his Twitter, though. Let's check his Twitter. And I check his Twitter from Discord at this point. Because I have my bot set up.
Oh, shit.
DSP the Unstoppable. I'm back from break and raring to go into another full week of fun. Now, this was what he was setting up. Plus, join me for Phil's day off. Plus, Game Pass Marathon. Polls. Fucking polls. I wonder if this pre-stream was terrible. As much as I think it is.
I don't know if there'll be any hidden items in this game or not. By the way...
I have no idea how somebody can find this entertaining. Because he's playing the game as much meandering as possible. He's meandering so much. It's just annoying.
Only fear of death says, so you've never put your doorknob between your cheeks to open the door? I have to admit, that's something I've never done. Django Pops says, I'm hyped to see you play this. Been busy lately, but I had the streams in the background while doing work. I have no clue how memberships work. I'm on my 6th or 7th month. You are. You've got your chat crown with the nice rubies and emeralds, and I appreciate the ongoing support. Django Pops. Awesome.
Yeah, Hate Army Watch sent me on Discord this screen cap.
Anti-smoking agenda. Beat him up.
Where is it? I forgot. I was tagged somewhere.
Oh, the rain stopped. Yeah, now that I'm inside, there's no vibration of the rain pitter-pattering.
Oh, no, but there's some memes. Let's look at some memes.
I think the haptic feedback's going to be
very nice.
Well in this one. Look at this guy.
He
kicked him in his upper thigh.
Are you playing the game?
Like,
all right.
Oh, my leg.
Let's look at the game for a little bit.
Ow.
He's stalling so hard. I don't know if he's afraid. Oh, now let's go change the fucking brightness again. He doesn't know if the game is too dark or not. Fucking idiot.
Wait a minute. I don't think it actually saved my lightness setting. My brightness.
Lightness setting.
Because I upped it before and now it's like...
Holy fuck, what an alien.
All right, let's see how this looks.
Oh, I don't know where you added me.
Much better? Is it too bright now? You guys let me know, I could down it one. But I agree with you that it was way too...
Oh, in the DSP thread, okay. I found it.
Nice computer desk.
Here it is, dude. Here it is. This is it. So first we have some guy. Then we have DSP Gaming. Then we have Dark Dave. Then we have some guy. Then we have Frogga. And then we have... I don't even know. But that is the next thing. And big ups for the sub. Eric Ort. Big ups, dude. I don't know where the pop-up went, but it played. Oh, it should have been here. All right.
These doors don't open.
All right.
Always hate those houses with those doors.
He's wandering around.
All right. So now, we're going to go. Oh, rush by holding R2. So that's how you run. Okay. I don't really want to rush up these stairs. Oh, I feel the pitter patter again.
Alright, I haven't seen a lot of this early gameplay of this, so I don't know when the first boss is going to come or anything, but this is just like very basic tutorial level.
I don't know where I got that.
That's why I was telling you today, don't get super excited for him being terrible. That's going to happen later on. When his reflexes have to kick in, he's going to get super exposed. But let's take a look at how he's gonna fight those people. Oh, you knew you could catch it. You knew that. He was watching all the guide videos.
Boom. What's this? R1. Oh, he kicked the stool and broke it. He's like, fuck it, I'm gonna break all the shit in your house. This won't help me in combat. I just want to steal all your shit. Yoink. Yeah, watch this. Break your fucking stool.
So lame. Bro, it's a new game. Just like play it normally. Why are you doing this fucking around? This is not 2010 anymore.
Randy, I'm very much still playing. The screen has not gone black.
And he's looking at his chat right now. What is he looking for, a reaction to his previous joke? Why was he just sitting around, not doing anything? Massive stall. Massively stalling, right, for no reason.
Prediction. I could be completely wrong, but I got a prediction. This is going to be one of those games, in the intro segment, you're incredibly badass, and you're just fucking everyone up, but then all of a sudden you lose all your abilities, and you're like a simpleton who can't fight at all, and now you got to go from the ground up, relearning everything. Like, it's going to be like Symphony of the Night.
All right, shut the fuck up. Play it. Let's see what it is. All your abilities,
you're like overpowered.
Holy fuck, DSP.
The fucking real game, now you suck, and you get your ass beat constantly. That's my prediction.
Yeah, okay, let's go. Let's see it happen. Why are you stalling so much? Is he scared from the game? Oh, wow. Now he has to fight, like, what, six people? What is this, five people? Yeah, it's like six people. Okay.
Dodge, okay, like this.
Okay, dodge. And he's probably not gonna start aging yet, but after this tutorial.
Oh, I fucking mistimed that.
Which, the tutorial, that's gonna take a while, I guess.
A lot of strikes.
Ooh, that was a nice hit. No, he's more terrified, not of dying in the game or being bad at the game. He's terrified of being relentlessly mocked for being bad at the game. Because if he was on Kiwi Farms to check if people talk shit that he didn't make the tips goal, he was on Kiwi Farms to see people mock him for being bad at the game in the future. So it's like for predicting that he's going to be terrible at the game. So now if he's terrible at the game, the trolls win. The trolls win, you guys. What are we going to do? I need to make a celebration feast and invite everybody. Because the trolls will have won. And if he's good at the game, man, he beats the trolls. And life is better. And now he's literally fucking around for no reason because he's scared.
Yeah, make him go to Home Goods after.
Or trying to be funny. I still can't figure it out. He's either trying to stall or be funny, which he's not. Because nobody in his chat is saying LOL.
They're playing a board game.
They're talking about money for some reason. $59.99, $40, $45. I don't know what this is about. Probably the price of the game.
They share collectively. You can't go upstairs? Why? You can't go upstairs because the stair broke? You can't step over that one stair.
What?
Wow.
All right. You can't step over it in real life, DSP. Your back hurts too much.
So we're going outside for probably a showdown. It looks like a traditional rooftop garden showdown. A la every kung fu movie ever and even Kill Bill.
Chill Bill. Chill Phil. The game he's playing is Sifu.
Oh,
S-I-F-U. It's a Mortal Kombat, not Mortal Kombat, martial arts game.
You came in here with a squad.
That is kind of a Souls-like or a roguelike. You know, where you... It's hard. You know what I mean? It's a hard game. So we expect some gold dust. Probably not today, though. I'm just watching this to see if... What's his mentality going into the game. Because right now is just stalling and being scared. And looking at chat for no reason. And chat is saying nothing interesting in any way. So, yeah. It's all everybody just like sitting around and waiting for nothing. You've gotten slow.
Sifu means master, by the way.
Oh, big ups to master. You know. Oh yeah, it's from the guys that make the Absolver games, those martial arts games. Those are martial arts, right? It wasn't like sword fighting. It was just hand to hand combat.
Damn.
Now we get a nice cutscene. I wonder what's gonna happen. I'm returning here tonight.
given me a second chance. This time, I will do what I must.
He's gonna fuck you up in slacks, baby. Oh, yeah.
Oh, so this is basically the first boss.
Alright, this is probably the first real fight of the game.
Or a mini boss.
Yeah, I already got fucked up. Double palm strike! Ooh!
Oh, that is cool as fuck. Okay. If we hit the tips goal, I'm gonna play this game, you guys. I know you love this game. I'm kidding, by the way. There's no tips goal.
Good dodge. I've been rocked and socked.
Well, he's doing okay. Yeah, kick him. Keep kicking him.
I'll be a nice guy.
Stomp him when he's down, like Pro Jared. All right, you broke him. Come on. Strike.
Ooh, another finisher. No, he comboed me. Oh,
yeah, because it's the... Isn't this the first boss that is supposed to beat your ass? I don't know. Some games do that.
I'm going to shit in your Wheaties, son.
When I look at you...
Okay, now the second form of the boss.
What a frightened, angry child.
When I look into your eyes, I see a sexy man.
Wow. A rainbow segment.
We just have different perspectives.
Sexy man, Phil. Did you forget you're married? How dare you talk like that? Sexy man. You find somebody sexy, you're married, Phil. Come on. It's illegal. In many countries around the world.
It appears so. Fuck. I can't parry him now.
Parry? Is that a reference to Perry?
There we go.
Perry Caravello, the best guy?
That was nice.
The cowboy man? The cowboy man fan? Come on, DSP. Counter him. Yeah, like this. Beat his ass.
Well, he was already
it's the first boss, come on. You can't literally die on the first boss. You're a gamer.
You punched me in the dick!
Wow, some more rainbows. Dick segment.
So what's in there? I came for the Godiva chocolates.
What? Chocolates?
Show yourself.
Oh, and he got an achievement. He always reacts when he gets an achievement. Well,
it's
the old master.
I'm a boy. Up the volume a bit? Okay.
You're a boy because...
There you go. I did a little
you're also already married to a girl, so you can't be a girl in the game. It's not cool. It's actually sexist. In many countries around the globe. So I guess he beat the tutorial level. The very, very basic tutorial. I guess he beat it.
He did. He killed and chopped his head right the fuck off. Damn. I was joking, but this game's pretty brutal.
I mean... Alright. Now there's gonna be a big... Wow.
Murdered.
It's gonna be a big cutscene now.
Luckily, he has a revive item.
It's gonna be very interesting.
One use to item, you get instant revive. Cool.
Father.
So that's his daddy.
So I guess you gotta find that that guy that you played as earlier.
Right?
Wow.
Killed my daddy, I come for you. He's out for revenge, like John Wick after his dog got killed. As we know, all actual kung fu movies are based off the plot of the John Wick trilogy. I don't know if you guys knew.
What? What?
The Botanist? Okay.
John... What? Bro.
Well, I've timed that...
Just stop. Correctly. Stop trying to make jokes. They don't work. Okay. Just like you.
See, he has a wind-up, and I'm not used to the wind-up animation. Kill Jafar the Botanist.
Shout out to Jafar the botanist.
Ooh, Take this, Jafar. Go back to fucking Arabia, you son of a bitch.
Whoa.
Go back in the fucking land.
Wow.
Yeah.
Go back to Arabia. Shout out to, whatever that was.
Down. Oh. Okay.
Wow. Bill. Bill.
Sean the fighter.
Come on, man. This is gonna go into a racism compilation video. You know that. Go, bro.
I parried it first. Fuck you.
Go back where you came from, Jafar.
Sean, that did not look like Sean from Third Strike, just so you guys know. It looked very different. But Sean, changed over the years. The artist. What the fuck? Palm Strike. Down, up.
Wow, that's a...
Down, it's a special move.
That's a pretty cool combo.
What the fuck is she fighting with? Looks like she's got the front of a shopping cart she ripped off or something. Oh god, that's a... It's actually like elaborate nunchucks. Fuck me up!
Hey, big ups Critical Gaming. Oh, we're watching some raw fill, and when I get bored, I guess I'm gonna be out of here. Or we're gonna watch some other clips.
Wow.
Because, I don't know. I don't know, I just wanted to see him be bad at this game, and it's not even the point of the game when he's gonna get bad. This is literally just the opening credits.
Now he's fighting the air. This guy just fights everything. Oh, she's got that fucking, the CEO. Oh my god.
Oh yeah, he's trying to be extra funny because it's part one of the playthrough. That's a good point.
Back forward and
that's a good point.
Triangle is a sweep and a down attack.
He's trying to be extra funny to catch all these new engagement people.
We gotta hold it.
Gotta say jokes about dicks and people going back where they came from because that's what gets people coming in. They get super excited when you're literally racist.
I got in her infinite combo. This is messed up, man. She only has one arm. You're fucking her up bad. Jesus fuck, that's messed up.
And he's going clown mode. It's very much more lively commentary than usual. Yeah, this game is gonna kick his ass. Because I've seen people way better than him at games get their ass kicked. He's not gonna have a nice time. It's gonna ease him in, and it's gonna make it seem like... You know, he's gonna get through it, but at some point it's gonna get really tough.
Oh shit! Oh!
That's my prediction anyways.
Jam,
I might play this game at some point. I don't know. If I gotta play a hard game like this, I might even stream playing it. Because it's fun to watch me lose my shit. We can have some goals, maybe every 10 deaths I'm gonna take shots or something, I don't know. Some fun stuff. Because this is definitely not fun. I think I'm thinking of playing the Outer Worlds. I'm not sure if I wanna. Because I've played it before, I completed it once already. And I thought it was fine, but I didn't really pay a lot of attention, so I might just go back in it and try it again. Alright, he's in the... I don't know, is this his base or something?
Fahar the Botanist.
Not sure.
Machete, mustache, who? He's the one who cut my throat that night. He's the first on my list. He works for a gang as a botanist and never leaves that warehouse. Okay, so here's this must be your intel.
Oh, you're doing a no-death run? Well, that's pretty crazy and on this game trying to do it.
It grants them access to a range of traditional healing methods to try to alleviate their pain. It has gained so strange of a reputation over the years thanks to so-called medical miracles. Yes, Battle Duck, fists will fly at this location. Yes, Jack Black does make an appearance in this game, Haseo. Yes. What? Yang is the leader. Trained and raised by my father and Sifu, we were close. He taught me a lot over the years. He disappeared with his wife and daughter when I was still a child. He came back years
ago. Okay, we get some spicy backstory.
He now lives alone in the city and runs a traditional healing center, but he doesn't appear to be in touch with the world.
Yeah, the salt is going to get gradually worse. In the beginning, it's going to be chilled, and it's going to be, wow, crazy.
She was always first to defend the underprivileged and helpless and always held a strong sense of justice. I don't know why she turned against them, but she'll pay for that. Now she has become the head of a vast and extremely powerful corporation. She's still helping those in need, albeit with greater means, but her sudden increase in wealth is very suspicious. How much do you want to bet? All right, I'm calling it. I'm calling it. You guys ready? You're gonna fight all these people and kill most of them. At the end of the game, you'll find out your dad was the villain, and that's why they stopped him.
Maybe. I don't know.
The highest building, it's called the tower. The highest building.
What if DSP just looked up a bunch of stuff on his day off? Jinfeng is our office at the top floor. I think that's also a good theory. What if DSP was the villain all along?
Sean?
And it was all just one big scam that we all fall into.
Kung Fu masters. I can't believe he took part in their deaths.
That's 1000%, dude. He was tricking us this entire time.
In the club? I'll need to get there early when it's not too crowded. Oh, wait. An infamous nightclub in the city. The owner is a good friend of Sean.
Yeah, he is dragging this out massively. That is a good point. I think also he's going to quit pretty quick. The point, what I think right now is, what his game plan is that he's going to play it really slow. Install his way as much as possible through this game. Until it gets hard, which at that point, when it gets really, really hard, it's going to be the point where he's played the game for a long time. The views are going to drop. Nobody's going to care. And he's going to have an excuse to move on to the next game without embarrassing himself. Because he knows he's not finishing this game. Most probably. And yeah, this gameplay sucks, but I get it. He's in the menu, basically in the menu still. In like the base.
So the guy that was
so obviously it's not going to be very entertaining.
Your dad's Sifu. So now your dad is your Sifu, and that's why you have his picture up as a this is his little shrine. I see. Maybe one day people will have a shrine to me.
What?
Yeah, a big stinky pile of shit. That'll be my shrine. So what do I do with this?
What? You're right with this, to be honest. You are right. A big stinky pile of shit is what his shrine is gonna be. That's exactly what it is. Oh yeah, Sifu is gonna be definitely a late kind of stream.
Nice combo.
It's gonna be a late chill stream and eventually it's gonna go away due to no support or low support. And he's gonna try and not rage too much, but it's DSP and he's very impulsive, so he will.
Knocks them back. You see
so
that?
You know what I mean?
That's pretty good.
Sounds good.
So if you're getting crowded by a bunch of enemies, you do the palm strike to knock one back, and then you can maybe focus on the others. While you're just one-on-one, you can... I swear I tried to push triangle there. If you're one-on-one, you sweep them, and you can do a down attack. And it seems like you have that meter in the bottom left-hand corner, you charge it up, and then eventually, when you have enough focus, you can do a special attack. Okay. Shout out to 500 hours who just tipped me $10. Says Sifu's intro is short.
Big ups, 500 hours.
And introduces the story in an intriguing way that leads.
Big ups, Dude Almighty, for showing up just in time for scat.
I guess we'll find out because it seems like we're gonna go right into the gameplay elements of the game now, right?
What do you mean? It's been what? 30 minutes? It's been 30 minutes since he started the game and he got the bare bones intro and the credits out of the way.
Tree. The literal skill tree.
Yes.
Holy shit, this is the first game ever. There's a literal skill tree.
It's not actually the first one.
360 swing focus. Look at that.
All right, I'll be back in a couple minutes. You guys enjoy this. All right, sounds good. Sweep attack.
Snap kick. Forward triangle. So I'm guessing I don't have some of these. Spin hook. Yeah, I don't have any of these. I unlock these later.
I'll be back when the gameplay starts. Ack, ack, ack.
Boom. Face smash focus for bat weapons will daze your enemies. Weapon catch. You can actually catch enemies in midair. Or catch enemies. Catch projectiles in midair. You see what I'm saying? Like when you started the game, you had all these cool abilities. Now apparently you don't have any. You have to buy these. All right. Well, there's no reason to really look at all these yet since I don't have them yet, right? But it's kind of a nice preview of the things you'll have. Sliding kick. I like that. Trill1, 817, just hit me $10. It says, Duma! Let's go, Sifu DSP. Thank you very much, Trill1, for the tip. We're now up to $49 in tips, guys. All right, then we should get to the first stage. What do you guys think? Should we dick around more in the intro? Let's dick around more. Let's see if they have a kitchen or something I can eat at, right? Actually, how do I leave? I don't know how to leave and go on the first mission. What am I supposed to do? The doors don't open. The skill tree I can't do anything with. right? I already looked at this. Do I have to look at it again? Oh, here we go. The squats. We're going to the squats. You know what comes after the squats, right? You know what you usually do when you're squatting, right? Exercising. Of course, you're exercising. I don't know what you guys were thinking of. Everyone's suggesting something different. Someone says I should get forward kick first. Swagnino says I should get the weapon catch first. Haseo says, if you look at the upper left-hand corner, that's your age in the skill tree. Yeah, I think what happens, from what I've heard when I read some previews and stuff of the game, as you play the game, the more you die, the older you get. So you could die and be like 700 years old. Okay, maybe not. I don't know how it actually works. Here we go. We're hitting the squats.
They've blocked the entrance to the warehouse.
What a bunch of fucking dicks. That's right. I know. I'll climb this wheelbarrow. No, I will not. I know. I'll go.
All right. What happened? The gameplay started? I'm sure it did.
No, I will not. I know. I'll go towards this very apparent blinking fence. Nothing here for you. Who's this asshole?
All right. Did he die already? I don't think so.
You called me an asshole?
He's age 20. You start from 20, right? You die around 75.
I'm assuming that's your health bar in the upper left-hand corner. All of a sudden, see the parrying stuff now. See, the parrying was much easier in the intro. Now it's harder to do. I'll try sweep.
Oh, no. The next donation he's going to get is going to be... There's going to be a pause, then he's going to put on the glasses, going to be a whole ceremony. It's going to be the whole thing. Pretty lame. And yeah, he 100% has read a guide or something. He's not going into this blind. Because yesterday was his day off, and yesterday people were playing the game. And talking about how bad he's going to be in it. So now he wants to prove everybody that he's going to be good.
Like Grand Theft Auto, going through like a office or a apartment building.
What? It's like Grand Theft Auto. What's upstairs? Let's see what's upstairs. Please, some enemies. Fight some people.
I missed my
sweep. Lol. Oh, he read some reviews. All right. That should be great. He hasn't died yet, so it's not too late for that. This game is pretty badass, though.
Listen to me, pal. Hey, buddy. No money, no goods. Why can't I, like, eat the items?
Junkies. I don't think they'll be a problem.
You're gonna beat up junkies?
Can I drink the drinks to get health back? No, you can only
grab. Oh, that's a toxic drink.
I want to drink. I want to recover. How do I recover my health?
Oh, is the hallway going to be soon? It's like the hallway fight in Old Boy, that Korean movie. It was a great fight. A great scene. They have it in this game as well.
So I guess that's it. All I did is I came through here and look at this guy.
Yeah, hit him with a bottle or something. I don't know.
All you do is grab some bottles.
He's a druggie.
You grab the bottle, then you go down here. You go for a jump. Oh, yes. You go this way. That's where you came, and you go the other way.
This is, by the way, how DSP wants to hook people into his channel. Shitty songs, scat jokes, and meandering. In literally part one of the playthrough. This is what he wants to hook people up with. This is the best he can offer.
Oh, yes.
Terrible improvised song. And scat jokes and dick jokes.
Investigate. Locked until we fucking say so. Found this note stuck on the door. Blocking my way to the warehouse floor.
The fuck, bro? Oh yeah, of course you can. You also have to wait 24 hours before you can literally write in his chat. Which is super productive, by the way.
Break it.
The fuck, dude?
That doesn't work.
But yeah, why can't he open the door?
Oh shit. Oh,
that's
shit.
Retarded.
I don't know how to go out of here. I can't open the window.
Why? Can't open. Why are you singing?
Can't open that.
Bro.
Cash only.
He went to the bottom floor. This is just meandering.
Look at this guy.
Okay, now beat his ass. Come on, make some action happen. It's an action game. Oh, and CM Fool gave him the money. Okay. Put on those glasses. Now it's time for a break. To put on the glasses. And be really slow putting on the glasses.
Got some tips. I got a tip from Ansel Kamaru. It's $1.52.
What?
You only recover health when you do a takedown.
Some musical stream now?
Go for the forward kick. You need a way to close the gap quickly and at all times.
Stay!
CM Fool also is tipping me $4.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
That's all you got for the whole game. You lie. How could you lie to me, CM Fool? Why would you lie to me? He's basically trying to throw me off, so I think one thing, and then I fail miserably. And just to find out that I ignored a game mechanic because I listened to him. How could you be like that, CM Fool? That's very mean. Okay.
Get a real fucking job.
I told you now there's gonna be the break. What is this? Elevator music?
Only have these
two. The fuck is happening?
That's it. See that? Cop.
Holy fuck. Close the tab right now.
Bro, we knew about that.
Right now. Close the fucking tab. What do I have in the other tab? Admits the troll's got more engagement than him. Let's talk about this for a little bit, I guess. Maybe. Because this is just garbage.
Heavy, light, heavy.
What are you looking at, chat? There's saying nothing. Okay, you have those glasses. Now just play the game. Please play the game. Please.
I'm coming for you.
Hey, you.
Hey, you. Hey, you.
Why is he singing? Stop singing, DSP. Hey, I'm punching these people in the face. And then some kung fu. Yeah, yeah. Dicks, dicks, ass. Liquid poo, ass. Dick, ass. Shitty dicks.
Run at it. I don't know how to run.
It's a great song.
Stylish. How you doing?
Yeah, that was a nice ass jump.
Bed? Oh, shit. Double takedown finish. Oh!
Yeah.
You were just standing around your underpants and someone ran inside with a fucking pipe and started beating your ass. Ooh, lightning hand.
Ooh, a trophy.
But I'll take it.
Yeah, take it.
Is it their junkies? Can I fuck this one up? Oh, it's not like Skyrim where they're asleep and you just beat the shit out of them in their sleep. Too bad, I love that.
He likes beating people while they're asleep. Confirmed. DSP to be confirmed a criminal or whatever. I don't know.
Clean your fucking place.
I don't fucking know what is happening on this stream anymore. What is happening? Why are we even here? Why are we watching this?
Purple mist?
For the jallies?
The drug produced here, it appeared a few years after the death of my father. It has uses.
Yeah, it's purple. Throughout the city. This, you add some water in it and it turns into lean.
Okay. Well, let's see here. Heard on the chat, you're saying raise the difficulty because they're stupid.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking.
Why are you asking for? I just started playing the fucking game.
Why are you toxic already? Yeah, it's. Oh, here it is.
Here we go.
Here it is, the hallway.
Now we're talking.
Yeah, you knew this was coming, huh? Mr. Blind playthrough.
Looks like we got a smart ass here, guys.
Oh, no. And yeah, he's gonna get destroyed by this game. The way they're hitting him now and he's not doing anything from time to time is just, yeah, this is gonna punish him a lot. If I definitely played this, I would be raging a lot.
One strike.
But I would stream it 100%. Because it's like,
another takedown.
If I'm gonna rage, at least I'm gonna get some views from it.
I really appreciate that, guys.
This is the most boring way you play through the sequence. You just wait for them in one spot. Keep going further in the hallway. That's the fun part of it.
I finally busted.
Well, of course, you beat up like 15 people with it.
You gotta get the one from this girl.
Yeah, get him clap.
Oh, fuck! Oh, it's mine now.
Yeah, he's taking it slow because he's trying to avoid it being too hard.
I'll put it down right in your ass.
Yeah, what? Ass? More ass?
Very nice.
Oh.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
There should have been a tip from Broso. You're right, I missed it.
Oh my god, no.
What are your thoughts?
Game is paused.
Suspects in game journalism complaining the game was developed by French white people.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck. They're making a video game.
They want, as long as the game is good, I don't care if they made it.
All right.
That's incredibly fucking stupid.
Right? Oh, that's incredibly stupid.
That would,
okay.
That would be like saying,
I think it's stupid too.
Listen how dumb this would be.
It's pretty dumb. Like, oh, play the game.
The only people who can make a game about Africa is someone who lives in Africa.
No, shut up. Play the game.
What?
All right. Play the game. You made your point. Oh, drinking water. Needs to write the tip. Oh, and it doesn't need. Okay. Ignore their shit.
Okay.
All right. He's going to get killed now, huh?
Super Mario Brothers was made by two Italian plumbers in fucking Brooklyn, right? Fucking idiots.
Bro. Fucking idiots.
Okay.
They're not. It's not enough for them to be wrong. They also need to be fucked in the head idiots. They can't just be wrong and have bad opinions. They have to also be morons, and you have to be better than them. Calls me every 2 seconds to check in. Yeah, sounds good. I agree with you, Ex Mortis. That's why I don't restream him usually as well. Just way too boring.
Oh,
and then we get these just segments of pausing the game, talking some bullshit, reading tips, writing the leaderboards, just so much derailment.
Drugs here.
Derailment. Then he would say some stupid joke and stomp the game to look at chat and look for their reactions, if they're laughing. Look for their validation.
Yes, freaking way. Oh god, they crowded me. They crowded me.
All right. Yeah, they're trying to gang up on him, but he's probably gonna beat them all up. These are like level one enemies.
When you do the finisher, it interrupts what everyone else is doing.
Yeah, and it gives you back health. So you should spam it as much as possible, I guess.
Oh, this guy's roiding up.
Yeah, he's buff. He's empowered.
Yeah, fight, bitch. Block this. He is blocking.
All right, he did. Oh, he almost got him killed. Okay. What?
I strike.
All right, attack. he did a cheap strike.
I think I did. I got him with a cheap ass attack.
He cheesed him. He eye poked him, otherwise he would die. No honor. Zero honor.
I'm pretty fucked right now.
Yeah. That was kind of funny. I mean, of course. You gotta use your mechanics. I don't blame him. I'm just making fun of him for the sake of it. He poked the guy.
When they flash the little bar, I'm not sure what that means. What's up, Nathan Smith? Good to see you here today. See him, fool. Tip me $4,
bro.
You know, all these people are minding their own business. You just come in and you fucking.
Oh, holy fuck, I mean, dude.
Right. They're just here making drugs.
Game is paused again because after every tip, he needs to calculate. What a bad fucking streamer.
It is kind of.
What a bad streamer.
This what is that?
Need to pause the game, and I'm here to watch the game, not necessarily him. I just want to see the game, like how the first levels go. So I know. Wow.
Revoltingly disgusting.
Yeah, you are. It's the kind of person you are. Where you would do it and then you would exactly say what it was and just say sorry as if you mean to be sorry about it. Wow.
Pick one reward. Increase the health you gain on a takedown. Increase maximum structure, which I'm assuming is your health. Weapons are built, increase your
If this is your first experience of the game, you're probably checked out a long time ago, because it's like the gameplay is just so cut apart with this nonsense. And the pausing and being in menus and walking around in a building. This is a terrible way to open up your stream as like the premiere of this game. He wants it to be bad. So he doesn't have to finish it because it's gonna get exposed for being trash, I guess.
I don't understand how this upgrade system works at all.
Yeah, did he pause 13 times? Is this actual Brandon?
I watch Old Boy, the Green Corridor was
that's the actual no. pause amount? Because that's pretty crazy. 13 times for what? An hour of playing the game? Less than an hour. 40 minutes. Effectively, 42 minutes, let's say. Oh no, that he played it for more and paused more. So he started 45 minutes. He was setting up his brightness. And he's still nowhere. He's played basically... My age is 15 minutes into the game or 20 minutes into the game.
I have 1,000 points
and now we're discussing what we're gonna upgrade. And big ups to Alex Monty for a super chat.
These I
can I tell Ex Mortis you said hi. Big ups Ex Mortis. Big ups Ex Mortis. Go watch his video on the SOK. It's a good video.
Improve weapon damage and impact on
opponents. You're gonna learn a lot of lessons such as how not to be retarded.
Just pick one reward. You guys can't see it. My camera is blocking it. Hold on. Pick one reward.
Wow.
So I could only pick one.
What an interactive stream.
So I could do any of these because I haven't died yet. I kind of think I should get more health because health I'm so low on right now. So I think I'm going to get health gained on takedowns. Right?
This is so boring. And his chat is just... Is it engaged? I guess they're talking about the menu. Oh, and now we're gonna pick skills.
So I can buy some stuff.
Ugh.
Stronger sweep.
Alright, these all look cool. I don't know, just get something.
New snap kick, engage attack.
It's like your first thing, man. Come on.
Snap, kick right in the nuts. Forward and triangle. You kick him right in the nuts. I wonder if you could do a follow-up combo after that. Spin hook kick.
Yeah, he's been paused the game for over 2 minutes now at this point. What was it, like... 2.5 minutes, I guess. Yeah, there is just pause. There's just no gameplay. We're discussing the future strategy of the playthrough.
Fuck you.
That's cool,
right. That sounds good. Weapon catch sounds good. Pushback cancel. You can stop it by pressing L1 when you're being pushed. A ground counter. When you're knocked down, you can still counter when you're on the ground. Environmental mastery. Throw an item weapon or...
Oh, and he's gonna go through all of them.
Double pops. This will make your...
He's gonna read every skill. There's like 20 more skills. 15.
Okay. Chasing strikes.
Reading every single one.
Crooked foot. After any parry...
Wow.
Triangle and release. And you'll do this combo.
Wow.
Duck strike.
That makes me cringe. Some weird, like, porno. That's retarded.
DSP can knock you out in a minute. In Street Fighter and in real life.
Dark Side Phil's erroneous use of tips and bits to fund his addiction to wrestling pixels.
You're gonna stay on my dick until you die.
Everyone hates me.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
It's different. Okay, it's different from the standard.
You get a real fucking job. You're still on mission one. You're begging for $10 and $20 to pay.
I'm gonna play the entire soundboard.
Until you die. Your life is nothing.
I love my life.
That's interesting.
I need to put disgusting food in the mouths of my family members.
That's kind
of pay my taxes, pay my back taxes, pay my utilities, pay my mortgage. Pay my internet bill, pay my utilities,
burn on the ovens and burn all the Jews.
I agree with you. I eBay. Right, you're constantly asking your viewers and your fans for contribution.
I think I like that. What people have
cuck
suggested,
life, 100%. Live the life of the cuck. Why not?
It's been
the
tough.
Snap kick,
you know, my life
triangle.
Has been tough over the last decade. It has.
Oh my God, he's drinking gin.
Life is your
me.
Teacher.
Me, scumbags and mental cases on the internet
will get
still support me.
That was my depression.
The company is for now production, internet content creation, both on demand and also live video streaming services.
Xbox has no games to be $1.50, and since the exclusives are dropping, early PS5s.
I literally played the entire soundboard while he was reading every single individual skill that you can unlock in this game. Every single one. He gave you the name and the description. And if he should use it or not. And now we are back to gaming. What was this? 5 minutes of literal nothing? 5 minutes. Over 5 minutes of garbage.
It doesn't work with the
garbage. Menu scrolling. It's like he's gonna order DoorDash or some shit.
No, it should, but it doesn't work. He does that instead.
Yeah, and he was he also gave a shout out to a tip or some contribution, I don't know.
Well, whatever.
play the whole soundboard. And there's still one spot that is to be taken. I haven't decided what to put there.
So far, I like it, but man, I lost a lot of health to that very tough enemy.
Yeah, go die. Come on.
I need to do a lot of takedowns to get health back, or I'm fucked and I'm gonna have to start over, I think. So let's find out.
Hey, how'd you get in here? Alright, go die already.
Wait, I got all my health back. Never mind. I had no idea I would get all my health back.
Well, maybe he saved it, like, I don't know how it's called, the save point. Or is there a save point?
Double parry takedown? Yes, look.
Yeah, double epic. Takedown. Like a real gamer.
I have a brick.
Yeah, he's made barely any progress.
I brick by accident. There's the
barely kick. Any for what, an hour of this. Now I can do the an hour after starting the game. Almost an hour.
Oh, they want me to jump into that.
Absolutely terrible.
Alright, let's make sure there's nothing else around here. Wait a minute.
This is how you don't have premiere streams.
Board game, I destroy it. What's this? Like cards, and I don't even know what that is. Soy sauce? Okay. Alright, I guess we gotta do this.
Okay, this looks like a boss. Oh, this is totally a mini boss at least.
Oh, it's a boss. He's beefy. A beefy boy. Oh shit, dodge!
Come on, the game is literally stopped.
Hold L1 and hold down.
The game had to stop so he can read this. Alright. Do they have pistol grips in this game?
Oh shit! I beat him!
Oh, that was pretty fast. What the fuck?
Oh no!
Wasn't even a boss.
Die, you release gas! Out of the way!
Alright. Scat.
He died asses up.
Scat, 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 scat.
Bill. Drug money.
Dude. I love it.
No doubt.
Hey, drug bills. Okay.
Oh my god. Ass is up.
What is the difficulty? I don't think there's a difficulty setting. This is the default one. This was just like a tutorial guy.
A gang member druggie, but
I guess. A druggie. Hates people that do drugs, by the way.
Mr. Cleanup in this bitch.
Mr. Jin. Mr.
Well,
Jin.
Elevator doesn't seem to... Oh shit! It's been tough. Oh my god, he's drinking gin. Yo, I thought I killed myself.
What?
Okay. Phew. I thought I had died my first death there. Hold on. Shh. Quiet. How you doing?
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
I guess there's no stealth takedowns.
He was lurking, that guy.
Paper trail going in there, but they won't let me in there.
Yeah. I like the bathrooms in games are pretty fun sometimes. Sometimes there's a corpse, sometimes there's a jump scare. Oh, we get another pause.
I'm a little busy.
Is it a soundboard segment?
$20, and he says using a void regains more stamina than parries.
All right, that's epic.
So here's the thing. I think when you parry, it leads you into
a lot of money plus. A lot of money plus advice, which makes it even more valuable.
So I think what it is it's a trade-off. It's probably easier to dodge than parry, but the dodge is more, the parry is more rewarding. So thank you, Brian, for a $25 tip. All right.
What did the other guy say?
Then I'm a little busy, tip 20, so that's 45 plus right. The 61 we currently
so
have.
So we break the goal. That's awesome. Now we need a hat. Oh my god, this is going to take 30 minutes.
Now time for a hat pull.
Oh no.
That's retarded. Some weird like porno.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
I'm gonna play all of them multiple times. And he's still not gonna be done.
Kung Fu.
Holy fuck. Which hat you guys think?
Pikachu.
Literally all of them are terrible. Literally all. Every single one is a shit hat. But a pilot is just like some Nazi shit. And a cowboy is cringe.
All right, let's continue.
You've seen him with a cowboy already. Pikachu is, I mean,
nothing.
I don't know.
Dingy ass bath.
He's just kind of a little lame. And the Viking is just cringe. All of them are bad. I don't want to be like- I'm just going to go with a pilot hat because it's a classic. I haven't played it yet. I'm going to get this pole out of here. The troll votes are going to be subtracted anyways. So it doesn't matter what I vote. He's gonna automatically detect my troll vote. That I sent from my 1,000 sock accounts.
Couldn't see.
Oh yeah, I guess the troll choice now is the Pikachu hat. But I didn't think deep enough about that. I was thinking short term, dude, not long term. Not the long troll. The small troll.
You get attacked from two different directions.
Gonna enjoy this.
I can't see! Oh, this
move the camera.
They fucked me up because I couldn't see what I was doing.
Come on, it's alright.
This guy's the mini
boss. Just spam him. It's not a mini boss.
Wow. I can't parry, I'm gonna die.
Oh, is he gonna die? No, he's gonna beat this guy, come on.
I narrowly beat him.
And now his health's gonna come back or something. Come on, this guy wasn't that...
Stand there and encounter hit you anyway. Holy shit.
Almost
died. So I guess that you don't look for healing items. You don't really look for much besides weapons or items for the story. I don't see any story items. All I see.
Yeah, let's walk around some more. Oh, this is lame. But I guess I don't have much better to do. We could watch this. Let's watch this little clip. While he's
Chris B says,
sitting
I think it's
around.
Definitely likely this channel can blow up in the next year, considering it blew up in 2011 and 12, and you've only gotten better since. The problem is the negative association with the channel and the fact that YouTube sorting is fucked up. Like, when you search for DSP Gaming, all the negative stuff would show up first. Why? Because
so what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the visual of his gameplay on so I can see if he's going to die, and I'm going to let him talk on this.
They are
because
putting out
fuck him.
That people are engaging with.
Yes.
People are liking it. People
yes.
are putting comments on it. So when people are saying, oh, DSP Gaming,
hey, what's up,
negative,
Almighty Bri?
Toxic hater videos show up first. Even if my channel is bigger, even if...
Your channel isn't bigger, that's the thing. Because YouTube determines how big your channel is by basically how many people like it and engage with the videos. And people don't engage with yours, and they do with ours. So we are not actually... You're not bigger than us. We are bigger than you. Because we're more people and we support each other. And you have nobody to support you outside of people that just give you money. And yeah, nobody even wants to give you a shout out.
Are more popular.
Oh, and he's in the menu again.
Which is dumb as fuck.
But and he died? Engagement is. Oh, he died. Come on, I fucking miss him dying. This was embarrassing.
Will always show up first. So that's why I need to build this channel back.
He needs to build this channel. Let's see him die. And all right, there we go. That was it.
Okay. That we got to do this, right? And then when the new releases hit, it's a natural thing that it gets that attention. And now people come to the channel and it grows the channel and people subscribe to the channel and the subs go up and the members go up and everything goes up like this.
Goes up like this. But no, it really doesn't because it's fake. I mean, his engagement isn't really legit actual engagement. His engagement is forced. Because he just pressures people and guilt trips people into subscribing and liking those streams and all this fucking nonsense and leaving unnecessary comments that they wouldn't normally want to leave. That's why his engagement isn't really real. It's not natural. It's not organic. It's just him telling people to do stuff. And people doing stuff because they want to do it out of their own accord is more valuable than you telling people to do stuff and them doing it. Because
you can reset your death counter
because you told them to do it. So yeah.
Okay. Does that decrease your age?
And we're in the menu section again. Let's finish this and I might just end the stream.
Everything goes up. I don't know why I'm dancing.
Why are you dancing, DSP?
Okay.
Is there more to this?
Oh, Jim the Frogger.
What did he say?
Subscribing when you also mentioned liking the video. You know, I mean, you're right. The thing is, I kind of auto assume that people who watch my content
auto assume
channel because number one, I have so many subs compared to the amount of views I get. Okay, that's number one. But number two, if you want to talk on the stream, you have to be subbed. So anyone who's chatting on the stream is already subscribed. But
but definitely that also kind of limits the people that you appeal to. Because, of course, the trolls are going to come in your chat and say gout, gout, gout 1,000 times. They can say that 1,000,000 times. They're going to get banned. But at that same time, you would prefer to have more people talk in your chat so you can rank higher in the algorithm. And that's going to motivate more trolls showing up and saying dumb stuff in chat. Of course, you have your mods to do it. And still, I mean, come on. It's,
You're absolutely right.
It's not really smart putting it on sub-only mode. You limit yourself to only people that are subscribed to you, obviously. So the new people that come, they can't even say hi in your chat.
Suggest.
That's ridiculous. Subscribe to the channel. Okay, we're back to actual gameplay.
Like the streams. Hey, like the videos. Leave a comment. Subscribe to the channel. You're absolutely correct. I should be saying that. I don't know why I haven't been.
Yeah, okay, so you should beg for subs now as well.
Expand Dong the Second says you brought great. Over 400 viewers for Dying Light's premiere, but you had sub-only mode on, and you said that there was little chatting. Maybe the only premiere stream should have sub-only mode off. All that would happen is trolling. I'm serious.
So what? Happening,
the trolls so what? Get wind that the sub-only mode is off, and they would come in with 700 clone accounts and say,
okay, you're going to get
disgusting stuff and just do everything they can to make you look bad.
That is to make you look bad.
As much as I understand your well intention behind
this is ridiculous. I mean, he is just like... And I know people are going to troll him. People are going to troll him anyways. Anyways.
Thank God they don't make you do that, huh?
But this is just like pulling him back, having all the sub only mode, and it's not helping him get more subs.
Great stream so far, and lots more coming. I am going
to. Doesn't really work like that.
But then
oh, when did he say turn on the ovens?
Turn on the ovens and burn all the Jews.
He said this during his debunk stream. Where it, of course, it's out of context. He was trying to quote himself in the Isaac Himmler accident when he was playing Dead Space and he went on the rant about Jews. So yeah, he was trying to quote that. We're almost there. Need to get through that door. All right. So what we learned today is that DSP wants engagement, any kind of engagement. You just have to drink the Kool-Aid. Yeah, as long as you contribute, you need to contribute if you like him, not to spite the trolls. Even though when you spied the trolls, you can see that as a win. And it's us versus them, but also we are not really engaging in this war. It's just like an imaginary enemy that will be there anyways, I guess. It's just bizarre, man. I can't explain anything. I'm so out of it right now. I'm confused by this gameplay. Oh no, he's getting clapped. He's cornered. What are you doing, DSP? You gotta get yourself out of there. All right, this got him some more health. Okay, all right, knock this guy out, and he fell, and he died.
I didn't know that could happen. I had no idea.
All right, that's his second death today, even though it says it's the first. Not sure how this works, but rest in peace, Phil.
It's like he tripped.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking.
Yeah, and when you have sub only mode, you kind of let people know off the bat that there's something wrong. It raises a lot of questions. Why would you have this? Wow. Are you getting trolled? No. Why are you getting trolled? What are people trolling you for? Wow. And he got destroyed again. Hey, this game is starting to get good.
He's getting destroyed. There's nothing I can do about this.
Hey, what's up, Mashenka? Maybe I'm gonna stay for another maybe half an hour. I don't know. He started to die a lot. If he gets really stuck on this section, he's already 24 years old in the game, so it's been tough.
The problem is after I parry.
Oh, and he's almost on the way out. Yet again. Okay, now he's stalling, walking around. Try finding an isolated enemy like this. Yeah. Okay, he got some health back. Oh.
I parried. I couldn't follow.
Well, obviously you didn't. And one hit. He's one hit away. Actually, two hits, probably. But now he's gonna get some health back.
I can't see. What am I supposed to do when I can't see?
Oh! gets clapped again.
And if the camera gets stuck, you can't see your opponent, you'll never be able to block or parry. That's
dark side Phil's erroneous use of tips and bits.
In a better way. That's really terrible.
And the yeah, he got dropkick. And he's 27. And you die when you're 70. Just like DSP. So this is starting to pick up. I don't know why it says two deaths again. Because I don't know, there's some weird mechanics. It's a special game. Special style game. Think Dark Souls.
That's really
big ups Mashenka for the 3 month membership. Who says 3 months as a mature adult, it's been penultimate. This is the penultimate benefits you get, man. You get everything. You get the emotes. You even get a name on your Discord that is highlighted if you link your YouTube to it. It's really lit, man. It's like the best thing you can do in life is be my member.
So I was getting older every day.
It's the best choice. Yeah, highlighted name in chat. You can vote on polls that never happen.
I don't even really understand it.
You can pick games that never get played.
Confusing mechanic at the start. Maybe I'll get to understand it more the more I play. All right, so I guess I fucked everybody up.
Yeah, you won. Boston. Oh, and now there's a big guy. Let's see, it's Jordy Jordan, you guys. It's Wings.
He's expecting me.
I don't think so. Only the long-haired guy visits him.
Yay.
No freaking way!
Wow, nice.
That was quick.
Oh, okay, now I get it. So the two deaths is how many years he's gonna age by.
So when
and when you beat a special guy, it goes down by one.
It's exactly the all same right. Attack as the kick, only
makes some sense, I guess. It's very interesting, good. Man.
I'm stunning them on advancement and I can do a follow-up combo. And you saw with the big guy.
So Jordy Jordan got destroyed. He got hit with a pistol grip.
So that's an incredibly good move. Forward, forward, and triangle.
Forward, forward, triangle. It's like now he's gonna be spamming it all the time. It's like Street Fighter. This is a good move, dude. I'm gonna use it literally every time.
Okay.
Now there's gonna be a boss fight, huh?
So if you down the person who downed you, you get a life back, but it does not de-age you. Okay.
Yeah, I like this game. I like it. It looks looks cool.
Fast enough, you can block and attack as you need to. You gotta be fast enough, and you can parry and throw enemies into others. I'm aware of that, but if I can't see the enemy, how do I know where to target? How do I know how to block? How do I know how to parry? How do I know how to dodge? And how do I know how to throw
if you can't see the enemy? So it's literally the game's fault.
That's the reason the camera should be focused properly so I can see.
Oh, yeah. This is the complaint from the reviews, by the way.
The enemies were in the corner.
The reviews were complaining about the camera.
Out of the corner,
and now it's his main complaint.
That was bad. That should be fixed. The camera should be better.
The camera should be fixed. Holy fuck.
Okay. So, at age 27, I can no longer up weapon durability, but I can still do health gained on takedown. So I feel like I should do that again. And as for the skill tree, once again, this snap kick is incredibly good. So I'm going to try to permanently unlock it again.
Yeah, eventually he's going to complain about the controls. That's 100%.
Until I have it permanently. So there you go.
Eventually, when he gets further into it.
All right, guys. So, this is a great opportunity for the break of the
stream. What? Oh, you can go fuck yourself, Darkside Phil. You can massively go fuck yourself. Because this is terrible. Let's see. Jasper Kidding went wild tearing up the living room due to neglect. Too bad I literally don't care about Jasper Kitty. Jasper Kitty can go to Ban World. You need to tip sooner. This is a clip that I want to watch. Then there's some rant about criticism, but that I didn't think it was interesting enough. And begs and then dismisses criticism. That's a DSP thing. So let me just see those two videos. See, maybe I have something to say about them.
Ladies and gentlemen,
and that's
going to
be it.
40 minutes into tonight's stream. What I would like to say
hey, 40 minutes. Statistic segment.
Super chatter. Go Team Venture. The only tipper of the night with a $5 tip.
Oh,
guys,
no.
If you like Pokemon, I'm going to ask you for a favor. Please support the streams. All right?
But what if I don't like Pokemon? What if I like you as a person?
A fun and lengthy playthrough. Of Pokemon Legends Arceus. Basically, I want to play at least 2 times a week, if not 3 on late night streams. But I've noticed, if you guys haven't noticed, the support for this playthrough has been almost non-existent.
Okay? Non-existent support.
I don't know why.
I don't know why. You're boring.
I've actually done well. This one, for some reason,
it doesn't matter.
I don't get it because this is the one that's actually innovating. It's not the same as the others. It
and now it's the game's fault.
Stuff differently.
Bill, you are boring. You make this game look worse than it is.
So
that is the problem.
If you are enjoying yourself, okay? You're having a good time, and you want to see Pokemon continue, please support the stream, okay?
What if I'm not enjoying myself?
Also, right now, guys, we have over 200 people watching the stream and about 46 likes. That's not
46
bad.
Likes? I don't know why this makes him look so pathetic. I have no idea why. But begging for likes is funnier to me than begging for tips. Because begging for tips at this point is a little bit worn out. But the likes begging, man, this shit is so fucking wild. It's so funny every time. Hey guys, we have this much people, but we have just this many likes. Come on. Oh my god. This is going to be one of those DSP arcs that's going to be remembered for this. It's just the begging for likes arc. And then it all went downhill, but it always does.
Watching the stream and having a good time and enjoying yourself, a way that you can actually support DSP Gaming without
no,
any kind of
fuck DSP Gaming.
By liking the stream. So please, if you're having a good time, please like. If you're watching this on demand on YouTube and you like it, please like it. Leave a comment.
But if I don't like it?
What do you think about the Pokemon I'm catching? Let me know about anything I'm screwing up or something I don't know about the region. And, of course, if you're not yet subbed to the channel, please consider subscribing. I'm trying to get 200,000 subscribers on DSP Gaming by my birthday in 2 months.
Lol.
It would be great if we
and when you say by my birthday, it makes you look like a man child. That's kind of the thing.
Upwards growth, so thank you guys. Okay. Little plug segment there. Get that out of the way.
And get it out of the way.
Being absolutely ridiculous. Doing a super chat saying people aren't tipping because they have to afford games themselves. I'm not even going to argue with
bro, it's like people aren't tipping for a million reasons. They're not supposed to be tipping. Tipping is a special thing. I don't know why he fails to understand it. Tipping is a special thing. You shouldn't expect tips. You should be grateful at tips if they exist, but you shouldn't expect them. I don't care if it's your job or not, because nobody forces you.
Silly stuff like that. I'm really not.
People aren't tipping, and then you wonder why they aren't tipping.
Seriously, we've already had many discussions on the streams about why people contribute, why they don't contribute, yada, yada, yada. I'm not here to get into the semantics of it. I'm just saying if you guys
the
like
semantics of tipping.
Streams. You know, there's other games that people are kind of upset right now that I'm not going to be playing as much. For example, Skyrim is now going to be a night stream. And people actually really support the Skyrim streams pretty strongly. So,
okay. Well, that's good because then you get more support on your night stream that is usually pretty slow.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
that's
I like
a good
to be
thing.
A variety streamer. I like to do a lot of variety of stuff. I don't like just doing the same thing over and over. And certainly I don't like making my streaming decisions based solely on financial reasons. And I don't. But if I'm seeing an ongoing
well,
pattern,
you have to. That's your job. That's your business. You have to. Or you beg, which you do. So, yeah, obviously you should.
I might have to make a decision I don't like. You know, I like this game. I want to keep playing. I told you.
Well, it's not about liking stuff.
Over the last week,
it's not about liking stuff.
I love the chill vibes of interacting with you guys. And you guys are talking about the Pokemon and helping me out to understand the game. And I really appreciate that. But I do need the stream to be supporting. I can't have it that every time I play Pokemon now, it's just totally slow night. So
terrible.
Like Pokemon,
terrible.
Like chilling with
it's
me
fucking
time,
terrible, beggar.
Like this, please support the stream tonight.
Terrible and so shameless, man. Like, how can you be this fucking guy and think that you're this important, that you can expect this amount of money every day?
Very Boom Boom says support was good on the Pokemon stream,
bro,
so
come
I turned it into a night stream. That's my fault. Oh, you do realize that I cannot play every single game in the same time slot, right?
Yeah, you can play more games. You can talk less and play more games. You need to tip sooner. This is the last thing I'm going to watch today. Then we go to an outro.
Now look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, I got to say something. I hope you guys understand. I have to say this. Perilla Gimp just tipped $21.69 and says, can you name a Pokemon Brosif Rules after my friend's Brosif? Yes. I can't. But what you need to do now is think of a Pokemon you want me to name that for next time. Because the stream is over. The stream is done. I'm done. I just saved. Okay? I appreciate that you're tipping. Why did you wait till now? And I mean it. Like, why did you wait,
why did you wait till now?
The stream off.
Do I owe you an explanation? He wants people to explain themselves to him. Explain why you didn't give me money earlier. Why? I am this important. You should explain to me.
I was about to turn it off.
Wow. He's something else, man. This guy is just from a different planet. Oh, and now turns around and click, click, click on the keyboard. Let's type him out. Terrible fucking streamer.
Totally isn't Gorilla Pimp, right?
Okay.
But $21 tip.
What fucking,
that gets us $54 in tips. Which means you get to see about 10 seconds of the Gunner glasses.
Okay. So what? Put them on.
There you go.
All right. No, and he's fucking disappointed, man. What a piece of shit.
This is silly.
What an actual piece of shit.
If this had happened early on in the stream, right? Then it wouldn't have looked as such a so bad of a stream. And on top of that, you know.
Oh, yeah. It didn't look like a bad of a stream.
Like, literally, the stream was going
on. Hilarious.
You didn't know.
You made me look bad by giving me money this late. This is what he wants to say. It would make the stream look bad.
I was going to talk extra at the end.
I cannot believe this person. I can't believe he is real.
I don't get it. I'm great.
I don't get it either.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. But you fucking pathetic.
Like that. That's terrible. Seriously.
He's fucking annoyed at getting money that he should be grateful for getting, for somebody going out of their way to toss his way for the free shit he's doing, that he's not entitled to this money, but you should have given it earlier.
Okay.
An actual alien.
Pokemon will be played at a reduced capacity. How reduced?
Reduced
Let's
capacity.
See how the week goes. I can tell you right now.
Brain.
I was already planning on doing Skyrim, Pokemon,
and more schedule. What's some more tips? Of course.
Hey, Phil.
And he's disappointed and gives the clown mode because somebody tipped him late. They gave him $20, but it was late, so you get this response.
Oh my goodness. You guys are going to give me a big splitting headache.
Giving him a headache. This guy is complete retard. Complete.
So now Dan the Man is the top tipper of the stream. Not
oh
Poodle
no.
Gimp.
How Sorry, how you, bothersome.
Man. Pokemon stream. So Dan, give it a
how
thought.
How bothersome.
Think about who it is that you want to name something. You saw my Pokemon. If you want, next time around, if you're around, what we could do is look at the inventory list of Pokemon again, and you could choose and think about what you want to name them. Obviously, you don't want two Dans, right? I'm pretty sure we don't want an entire army of Dans. We want different names for the Pokemon. Okay. Good Lord. Thank you very much, Go Team Venture. He says, have a great evening. Come on for you. Middle of the week, around Wednesday.
Bro, you're full of retard.
Carlos, thank you for the super chat.
And that's going to be it for today. What music am I going to play? I have no idea, but this is where the stream ends. Thanks, everybody, for checking in tonight, for clocking into your jab. Thanks for the chill. And we're going to be ending it soon. Let's hear... I don't know. I can't see any songs. Sounds good. I don't know. Just silence? Depressing silence for 10 minutes. No, let's play Carrie Diamond. And that's all for today.
Big ups, Liquid
Rich. Big ups for clocking in, for your contribution.
Pick up the new album, Carrie Diamond.
Don't forget to take all your stuff going home and stay safe. All right. Big ups, everybody. See you around. Join the Discord.
Dumbass scrub.
I'm lurking.
What the fuck?
Peanut butter complexion style.
Yeah, I got 100 likes. That's amazing. Let's go for 10,000.
I'll be that monkey.
How are you? Fat man in my phone. You play Rainbow Six Siege all day when I'm home.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least
all
expect
day
it.
When I'm home. Stay home. Carry you more. Cause you shine so bright.
You're still on mission one.
You look like the sun.
Turn on the ovens and
even in the middle of the night.
I need to put disgusting food in the mouths of my family.
Money is to be made and spent.
Fuck life.
Bend me over. Bend me over. And stroke my BBC.
Oh my god!
Play the fucking set.
Get that ass bent.
Visualize me in a bed.
I'm lurking.
Visualize me in a bed.
mouth wide open and cheeks spread.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
I'm a working motherfucker. I represent new age blacks. Can't believe that you just asked. Please go jack off.
You're like, how are you, fat man in my phone? You play Rainbow Six Siege all day when I'm home. All day when I'm home. You shine so bright. You look like the sun, even in the middle of the night. My mod should be doing this. I gotta play all day slay. All day slay. Fireman Candor, can you please do a band? Shout out to Big Cheese. Fuck Kiwi Farms. Joke's on Lynn. I'm pulling back from Brandy. Got black Kenny Pagan. Prozac. Kenny Pagan. Prozac. Black people black. Brandy. Black people, black, Brandy. I'm going back. Don't criticize what I'm doing on the screen. Food, that's just more gas tank for the love machine. For the love machine. How are you, fat man in my phone? You play Rainbow Six Siege all day when I'm home. All day when I'm home.
Burn on the oven. Burn on the oven. Burn, burn, burn.
I'm
in
you. I'm lurking.
Cause you shine so bright.
I'm lurking.
You look like the sun.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking
in the middle of the night.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
Dark side fills the pieces with tips and bits to find his addiction to wrestling.
You look like the sun.
New album today. Shout out Sean B.
I know there's gonna be a lot of people out there calling.